It's time now for Fort Stockton High School Prowler Basketball on KFST AM and FM, KFSTRadio.com, and KFST's Facebook and YouTube pages. Prowler Basketball is being brought to you by Amistad Motors, Angie Miles at Turnkey Realty, Glitzy Trends and Glitzy Brew, Bienvenidos Mexican Food, Ram Country, Triple G Supply and Services, Rainwater Motor Company, The Steakhouse Restaurant, Big Ben Concrete, Bucks Loop Center, Cactus Health Services, Citibank, Concept Inc., Contessa Ready Mix, CTG Express, Designer Carpets and Interiors, The First National Bank, Fort Stockton ISD, Fort Stockton Insurance Agency, The Guadalajara Mexican Grill, Hernandez Sanitation, Heritage Funeral Home, by Julie's Easy Press, K-Bob Steakhouse, M&J Trucking, M&J Fast Loop, Sawyer Insurance, Porky's Ice House, Stockton Glass and Mirror, Triple R Welding, Weiss Tire, Salceda Urgent Care and Family Medicine, by Sagebrush Cafe, Permian Basin Abstract, West Texas Eye Care, Pecos County State Bank, Little Regina Trucking, R&K Rentals and Party Supplies, and Besitos de Azúcar. Now stay tuned for Prowler Basketball.
Ken Ripley, and we are live here at Fort Stockton at KFST, AM and FM, and KFSTRadio.com. And we've got Prowler Basketball coming up here on KFST. We'll be back right after these words.
It's time now for Fort Stockton High School Prowler Basketball on KFST, AM and FM, KFSTRadio.com, and KFST's Facebook and YouTube pages. Prowler Basketball is being brought to you by Amistad Motors, Angie Miles at Turnkey Realty, Glitzy Trends and Glitzy Brew, Bienvenidos Mexican Food, Ram Country, Triple G Supply and Services, Rainwater Motor Company, The Steakhouse Restaurant, Big Ben Concrete, Bucks Loop Center, Cactus Health Services, Citibank, Concept Inc., Contessa Ready Mix, CTG Express, Designer Carpets and Interiors, The First National Bank, Fort Stockton ISD, Fort Stockton Insurance Agency, The Guadalajara Mexican Grill, Hernandez Sanitation, Heritage Funeral Home, by Julie's Easy Press, K-Bob Steakhouse, M&J Trucking, M&J Fast Loop, Sawyer Insurance, Porky's Ice House, Stockton Glass and Mirror, Triple R Welding, Weiss Tire, Salceda Urgent Care and Family Medicine, by Sagebrush Cafe, Permian Basin Abstract, West Texas Eye Care, Pecos County State Bank, Little Regina Trucking, R&K Rentals and Party Supplies, and Besitos de Azúcar. Now stay tuned for Prowler Basketball.
You're listening. Good evening, everyone.
Hey Panther fans, this is Rudy Franco with Amistad Motors, inviting you to come out and take a look at our pre-owned inventory. We have a good selection of cars, trucks, and SUVs. We have several certified pre-owned units that come with an extended warranty. So if you are in the market for a new or pre-owned vehicle, drive on over to 2110 West Dickinson or give us a call at 336-9000. Amistad Motors, friends serving friends. Go Blue!
And good evening, everyone. This is Ken Ripley, and we're live here from the Special Events Center tonight. Fort Stockton Prowler Basketball coming up here on KFST. We'll be back in just a moment. Your local real estate professional is Angie Miles at Turnkey Realty, offering experienced, professional, knowledgeable, and friendly real estate consultation. Angie Miles has over 30 years of sales experience and serves the entire Trans-Pecos area, including Fort Stockton, Pecos, Alpine, and Southwest Texas. She can show any listing and can list your residential, commercial, or farm and ranch property, and also offers property management services for all your real estate needs. Contact Angie Miles with Turnkey Realty, 804 North Main, or call 290-8038. Glitzy Trends and the Glitzy Brew Coffee Shop is located at 1101 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton. Open Tuesday through Saturday. They offer delicious coffee, tea, smoothies, hot chocolate, fresh pastries, and desserts. Come down for bingo and loteria on Thursdays at 7 p.m. And Saturdays, Glitzy Trends has all-day games like darts, indoor cornhole, Jenga, checkers, chess, and board games. Come by Glitzy Trends and Glitzy Brew today, 1101 West Dickinson.
And good evening, everyone. This is Ken Ripley, and we're live from the Special Events Center tonight. The Fort Stockton Prowlers will be playing a very important game tonight against the Andrews Lady Mustangs on senior night. The seniors were introduced tonight, and we have Amaya Urias, who is a senior, also Ivana Ortiz, a senior, and Sophie Hernandez. So just three seniors, and they were honored prior to tonight's game. Congratulations to them. And they have made, hopefully, the playoffs, unless, of course, Pecos were able to beat Greenwood tonight and we lose to Andrews, then there's a possibility that we could tie Pecos for that fourth place playoff spot. But hopefully, certainly Greenwood will get the victory over Pecos tonight. I believe they will. Well, the Andrews Lady Mustangs are coached by Dylan Ballard, and they are 13-9 overall, 6-3 in district play. So they are tied with Greenwood for second place tonight, and Greenwood will play Pecos. So this is a very important game for Andrews as well. Fort Stockton comes in 14-15 overall, 3-6 in district play. The Prowlers are right now in fourth place in the district race, and we're looking to go into the playoffs. And if the Prowlers do make the playoffs, it will be Canyon, the number one team out of the Northern District, I believe, that we will have to play. All right, so we'll be back in just a moment. We've got the rosters for both ball clubs right after these words.
Do you know where you can get a great lunch special for a very affordable price? At Bienvenidos Mexican Food Restaurant, of course. Their lunch special is served Monday through Friday during lunchtime. Monday, it's the taco plate. Tuesday, it's the grilled chicken salad. Wednesday, it's Bienvenidos Nachos. Thursday, it's the hamburger basket. And Friday, it's the enchilada plate. You can come by Sunday through Friday from 9 to 11 a.m. for a delicious Mexican-style breakfast. Bienvenidos, open Sunday through Friday, starting at 9 a.m. at 405 East Dickinson.
Ram Country in Fort Stockton presents Warranty Forever, a warranty like no other, now covering every new Ram purchase from Fort Stockton's exclusive Ram dealer. No mileage limit, no year limit. Your new Ram is protected forever at no extra charge. Plus, Ram Country's Warranty Forever has no deductible and all parts and labor are covered. Log on to RamCountryFortStockton.com to shop online anytime. Then hurry to Ram Country and get your warranty forever at no extra charge.
All right, let's take a look at the rosters for both of our ball clubs tonight. Andrews, coached by Dylan Ballard. They're 13-19 overall, and they've done pretty well in district play. They are tied right now for second with the Greenwood Rangerettes. They'll have a 5'6 senior point guard, Charlize Rondon. She's a starter, a 5'5 junior point guard, number two, Anae Mojia. A 5'3 junior guard, number three, Tori Rodea. A 5'4 sophomore guard and a starter, number five, Kiki Morrison. Number 10, a 5'5 junior forward and a starter, Cassine Tijerina. Number 11, a starter, Carly Colbath. She's a 5'10 junior center. Number 15 for Andrews is a 5'3 senior guard, Dana Rodriguez. Number 22, a 5'5 junior forward, Janelle Espinosa. Number 23, a 5'5 freshman forward, Danley Fisher. Also, we have number 32, a 5'10 junior center and a starter, Allie Fulford. And number 34, a 5'4 senior forward, Abigail Jimenez. All right, so those are the Andrews Lady Mustangs. Again, tied for second in the district coming into tonight, right behind Seminole. Seminole, of course, is undefeated in the district at 9-0. And they are ranked number 5 in the state. All right, the Fort Stockton Prowlers 14-15 overall, 3-6 in district play. And we will have 5'4 sophomore guard and a starter, number 1, Theata Wieslaar. Number 2 is Lizeth Robles. She is a 5'3 junior guard. Number 3 is a 5'10 senior center, Amaya Urias, a starter. Number 5 is a 5'5 senior guard, Ivana Ortiz, also a starter. Number 11, a 5'2 freshman forward, Carissa Salmon. Victoria Maldonado, number 12, a 5'4 sophomore guard. Number 13 is Addison Castro, a 5' sophomore guard. And number 15, Alondra Encinas, a 5'6 freshman forward. And number 21 is a 5'8 sophomore forward, Kimberly Norman. Kaylin Reeves at number 23, a 5'6 freshman guard. And Sophie Hernandez, number 24, a 5'8 senior center. We'll be back in just a moment. When you need supplies in the oil field, the choice is clear. Choose Triple G Supply and Services in Fort Stockton. They have all the oil field supplies you need, including general oil field supplies, PVC pipe and fittings, hydraulic hoses, generators, safety equipment, household supplies, and much more. They also have roustabout services available. Triple G Supply and Services is right here in Fort Stockton at the west end of Dickinson at 1048 Crockett Avenue. Delivery is available to your location. Call 336-8284 Triple G Supply and Services. The Steakhouse Restaurant is back open again after a brief closure with new ownership and management, but still staying in the Pacheco family. The Steakhouse has been serving Fort Stockton and the surrounding area with consistently great food and fast, friendly service. They offer fantastic daily luncheon specials on weekdays at a great value. Each special comes with appropriate sides, soup or salad, and drink. Come by for a great meal. The Steakhouse Restaurant in Fort Stockton at 1100 West Dickinson.
Big Bend Concrete can provide quality, ready-mix concrete for any job you need to tackle. From a simple sidewalk or driveway to bigger projects that require multiple trucks for larger pours, or on-site batch plant setups at remote locations for commercial or private endeavors. You make the call, they'll make the pour. Proud to be the number one concrete provider in the Trans-Pecos Big Bend area, Big Bend Concrete, 837-7179. Solid.
Buck's Lube Center is located at 310 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton. They feature quick oil changes, multi-point vehicle checks, inspection stickers, and fuel filters for all vehicles, specializing in mobile oil but with Motorcraft also in stock. Buck's Lube Center is open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. until 5 p.m. Remember, for reasonable prices and great service, it's Buck's Lube Center, 310 West Dickinson, Fort Stockton. They hope to serve you on every oil change. All right, our players are being introduced here at the Special Events Center. National Anthem has been played, and that means we're just about ready for Prowler basketball tipping off their last game for this season here at the Special Events Center. The Prowlers will be playing Canyon, I believe, in the playoffs. I believe that's who we're going to play, as Canyon was the number one team in the district up north. And that will be a very, very tough opponent for the Prowlers in that first round of the playoffs in Bi-District. All of those northern teams are very good, and I'm sure they'll challenge every team in this district. Well, the Andrews Lady Mustangs, 6-3 in the district, tied with Greenwood for second place. And, of course, Greenwood plays at Pecos tonight. We expect Greenwood is going to win that game, but you know what? The Prowlers could get possibly an upset here over Andrews tonight. I would love to see that. And the last time we played Andrews, we only lost to them at their place by 8 points, and had a very poor fourth quarter in that game. I don't think we scored a field goal in that fourth quarter. Yeah, we did. But we had a low-scoring second half in that game against Andrews. And Andrews' inside game looked, you know, decent in that game against Fort Stockton. And so we're ready to go here for the Prowlers. All right. We've got Theodore Wieslar, Amaya Urias, Ivana Ortiz, Kimbri Norman, and Kaylin Reeves, the starters for the Prowlers tonight. And here's the tip. That is controlled by the Prowlers. It goes to Ivana Ortiz. And here's the Theodore Wieslar out at the top of the key and bringing it across. And here comes Fort Stockton with pass over to the right wing, and there's Amaya losing the ball there on the dribble, trying to go into the lane, and it just goes right out of bounds off of Amaya, and it will be Andrews' ball. Now we see some backcourt pressure by the Prowlers, and Andrews breaks it very quickly, and they've got a layup, which they miss, by number 32, Allie Fulford. So that was a break for the Prowlers, and Daryl Scott is now here with me after a victorious game for the JV girls, right?
Yeah, 45-40, kind of a revenge after losing in Andrews. So
that was a nice game then, 45-40. The JV Prowlers win tonight. That was in the back gym tonight because the JV boys, they lost their game here, and that's a bad pass by Amaya, too high for everybody. And Kaylin Reeves can't get hold of that pass, and that's a turnover. So the Prowlers with 7:09 to go first quarter, we are scoreless against the Lady Mustangs. Daryl, the last time we played Andrews up there, we lost, but only by 8 points. So I'm thinking maybe this is a game that we can possibly win.
I think so. I think we're playing a little bit better. And
all right, there's a jumper by Kaylin Reeves just inside the lane. Oh, they're going to call a charge on Kaylin Reeves.
I don't see that at all.
I thought that was a blocking foul for sure, but they call a charge on Reeves. All right, here's Andrews inbounding the ball. We've got some backcourt. That's a steal by Amaya. Pulls up for the jumper over the hoop. No good. And it's Ivana with the rebound. Now here's Kimbri Norman over on the left wing. Goes back to Ivana. The seniors were honored here tonight, just three of them. And there's a steal by Andrews. Got it away from Ivana. And now here come the Lady Mustangs in the lane. That is good. That's going to be a 2-1 as Andrews scores with a floater, and it'll be Ivana Ortiz call for the foul, number 5 for the Prowlers.
And I think, you know, we've really got to cut down the turnovers if we're going to win this game. And she was out of control. It's just kind of lucky it went in.
And that is a good free throw by Kiki Morrison. And so that will give Andrews a 3-0 lead here in the first quarter. And that is dribbled away from or knocked out of the hands of Kimbri Norman by Andrews. It'll be Fort Stockton ball here on our own baseline. The Ottawa slot to inbound. Early first quarter here with 6:23 to go in this first period. Man, they're trying to challenge everything, even the inbounds plays. Look like close to being a foul. And that may be a foul over the back on Amaya. Number 32 for Andrews, Allie Fulford, and she's their center, and she's called for the foul over Amaya's back.
Must have been before the shot, but she was shooting.
Yep. Here's the inbounds play. Got to hurry. Kimbri Norman takes it at the top of the key. All right, here's the Ottawa slot out front now, and we're down 3-0. A handoff to Ivana. There's Ivana back out to Amaya at the top of the key, and there's nobody inside right now. We've got everybody out on the perimeter trying to work it into Amaya. We do. And Amaya puts it up and in off the glass. That was a nice shot by Amaya Urias and a nice pass also.
Yeah, and then we turn around and fouled. So.
Oh, wow.
After a really good play by Amaya, that'll work all night long. And that's second one on Reeves.
That is the second foul on Kaylin Reeves already. And that was in the backcourt. Kind of a needless foul, really. Kiki Morrison now brings it across for Andrews. Now they've got Charlize Rondon. 5:37 to go in the first quarter. 3-2. It's Andrews in the lead by one. Andrews at the left wing now with Rondon. Oh, what a beautiful play. They found Kiki Morrison wide open and score the basket easily.
Well, somebody let her loose. She was there by herself under the basket.
Point blank
pressure.
Shot, and there's a steal away from Theata, and the shot is no good by Rondon. And Andrews has it again. They go over to the left wing to Morrison. You know, Daryl, Andrews is tied for second in the district with Greenwood. Kind of surprising this year how well they've done, but they're not bad. They actually have a decent inside game.
Yeah, and they've very quick.
And here's the shot off the glass. That's good by Allie Fulford. That's a nice shot. And, Darrell, I really do, even though it's Andrews, I like to see a team use the glass like that. And there's another turnover.
That's a good way to make baskets is to use the glass.
It really is. Victoria Maldonado lost the ball on the out-of-bounds line, bringing it down the sideline, and Andrews forces us into another turnover. Kiki Morrison out front now for the Lady Mustangs. Well, they're leading by five here early. We need to get our offense going, Darrell, and we need to stop turning that ball over.
Got to control the ball and take care of it.
All right, here's Andrews. And they're working it around toward the lane. The shot is short, but they get an offensive rebound. Now in the lane, turnaround jumper, no good. And Amaya Urias is fouled, I believe, over the back after the rebound. And that might be Fulford again for her second foul. It is. Their 5'10 junior center got her second foul.
Yeah, they're going to pull her out. That's a good foul to get on her.
Got to hurry. That's Victoria Maldonado. She's going to be fouled maybe by Morrison. Yeah, number five on Andrews gets her foul. And here's your granddaughter, Aubrey Jones, who just got finished with the JV game.
Good game.
Congratulations, Aubrey, on the win. And here is Ivana Ortiz bringing it down now for the Prowlers. Amaya open for the shot, misses it. And Andrews has the defensive rebound, and here comes Charlize Rondon. It was a nice look at the basket, Darrell, but we missed the shot.
Yeah, that's where maybe the backboard does help a little bit.
Yep.
Right now, Andrews they're coming up with almost every loose ball, and that's something we need to shut down as well.
Yeah, we're going to have to get some – I believe it's Seminole, their boys in particular, so good at offensive rebounding. And it makes a huge difference. You know, second and third chances are great. There's a three attempted by Andrews. That's no good. And they will be out of bounds.
He's calling it for Seminole. For Andrews.
I don't understand that. I don't see how that is.
Coach Bishop
saw it. They reversed it.
Okay.
that's good. Okay. And here's the inbounds play by Fort Stockton. We've now got big-time backcourt pressure by Andrews. And here comes Ivana Ortiz down the right sideline. Ivana thought about a three, did not take it. Wow, she goes up for a floater. She looked like
Amaya,
she was fouled on the wrist.
I thought she was fouled.
But nothing was called. And here comes Kiki Morrison now for Andrews down the other way.
Watch when they shoot how you'll see five black jerseys crashing the boards, and that's I think, what you're saying Seminole does. Mm-hmm. So.
Yep. And here's Morrison out front. Pretty good ball handler there in Morrison. Mm-hmm. All right, here's Morrison over to Mohia. On Mohia.
I bet they called 50 travels in the JV game.
Yeah. We've got 2:40 left in this first quarter. Very low scoring quarter for our Prowlers. Oh, that is a bad pass. I don't understand that.
There's no rush there. There's no reason to throw it all the way down the court.
All right, Morrison back out front now after Fort Stockton turns it over again. We didn't even get a shot off that time. And there's a turnover by Andrews. And now that was a bump in the back by Andrews, but Theodowee Slaughter loses the ball. They didn't call a foul. And they're going to give it to Fort Stockton here with Wieslauter inbounding on our baseline. We need a basket or two.
We need a basket right now.
All right, here's Amaya putting up the floater. Ooh. No good. It's off the back iron. And Andrews with another rebound. Here they come with Morrison. Scooper, no good. And Ivana Ortiz being challenged on that rebound. Andrews kicks it out of bounds, and it will be Fort Stockton ball. But you see how hard they're fighting in the backcourt for those rebounds.
And they contest every ball. If you stand there and holding it, they're coming after you.
And here comes Theodowee Slaughter to Maldonado. All right, this goes to Encinas, who's in the game. Now what do we got?
That's a tie ball. She just pivoted her foot, and the other girl was right there to grab it.
Well, Andrews is playing much better defense than we are at the moment, and we just cannot get the ball down.
Had a couple of baskets, and we're healed. So
true, because we're only down by five.
We've locked them down a little bit better defensively here.
Morrison goes inside the floater. That is a beautiful shot by Kiki Morrison, and Daryl, she has 7 of their 9 points.
Well, she's going to have to be somebody we better guard.
Theodore Wieslaw over to Ivana Ortiz. Kind of a lazy pass, but we do get it across now the midcourt line. Minute 23, and we've only scored 2 points in the first quarter. That's Amaya near the free throw line. She goes to Wieslaw on the right wing. I would not be opposed also to trying some three-pointers.
Yeah, get some shots off.
That is a foul over on the left wing on Andrews, I believe. Number four.
No, he's calling it on us.
Are you kidding? Huh. Well, that is very interesting.
We've
got a timeout.
Yeah.
Timeout on the court. We'll be back after this. R&K Rentals and Party Supplies timeout.
Cactus Health is your one-stop health care facility. They care. Offering quality health care for you and your family, including health education, hearing screenings, adult and children immunizations, minor x-rays, postpartum care, OB care, prenatal services, men's and women's health, and lab services. Cactus Health, located at 700 North Main Street, call 336-8110 for information and appointments.
Well, we're back in the first quarter, and Daryl, the problem right now is we are not able to score. We've not hit. We've got a very low shooting percentage, obviously, and Andrews has gotten a lot of steals away from us. And we have been called, it looks like, for 4 fouls, team fouls, and Andrews has been called for 5 now, so we are in the bonus in this quarter.
Yeah, and they're bringing the ball down. You don't like me shaking your...
You're shaking the camera there, boy.
That's called the Lightfoot curse.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, well, I don't know if it's a curse, but I won't shake my foot if you'll remind me.
9-2 is our score, by the way, and we've got under a minute to go in this first period. And here's Fort Stockton inbounding the ball to Ivana Ortiz from Maldonado. There's Maldonado. Overshoots everybody. Bad pass, so we turn it over yet again.
And, you know, Ken, you've got to try to beat that press to make them quit doing it. And right now there's no reason for them to stop. Good steal.
She paid them back with a steal of her own, Victoria did. And she's going to lose the ball out of bounds, and they're going to give it to Andrews. She was trying to go down there for a layup, and she was double-teamed. Had a defender on either side of her. And here's a long pass, and Andrews loses it out of bounds. Man, to Carly Colbath, and she was wide open.
She was wide open. There wasn't anybody in the half court with her. Thank goodness for Butterfingers.
Inbounds play for Ortiz to Amaya to Maldonado. And what I think we need to do is just not get rattled by that press at this point. Here is a nice shot by Alondra Encinas. That time we broke the press. And that's an M&J fast loop, fast break, and Alondra scores. All right, here comes Andrews, and they got a fast break. That shot is overshot, and it's no good. And now that's the end of the first quarter. We're fortunate they didn't score on that last possession.
Yeah.
9-4, Andrews in the lead at the end of one. We'll be back after this, and that's your Little Regina Trucking game score.
Your dreams are what power our community. When it comes to buying a home, starting a business, or tools to help with everyday money management, Citibank is a proud community leader for your financial needs. From personal checking and lending solutions to mobile banking and a suite of business services, our goal is to help you achieve yours. Citibank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Are you sick and tired of inflation driving up the price on virtually everything? At CTG Express Oil Change, we have mastered the art of inflation-proof, lightning-fast oil changes. We tell inflation to take a hike with our happy hour discounts every weekday, 11 to 1 p.m., and our service appreciation discounts for local teachers, military, first responders, and correctional officers. We're fast, too, saving you time and money. And remember, at Seacheck Express, we are the best for the most dependable place to get your state inspection. Come stay with us at Seacheck Express in Fort Stockton.
Designer Carpets and Interiors has become known in Fort Stockton as the remodeling experts. They will be glad to put together a free estimate on just about any remodeling project, always keeping in mind your budget. They also can help with ideas and designs for your project to upgrade your home and add to its value. They also have all types of the latest and most modern flooring, including carpet, tile, hardwood, laminates, custom cabinetry, countertops, and much more. Call Designer Carpets and Interiors today at 336-6591.
Concept Inc. is.
All right, we're back, and we've got the second quarter starting here with Fort Stockton. Wow, I tell you, that Kiki Morrison, it looked like a foul to me, but nothing was called. I mean, that was a lot of contact. Andrews is playing very aggressively on defense, and they've gotten away with some fouls tonight, I think. Here's Victoria with a three, and it's no good. Nice rebound by Sophia, and her putback was no good. She shot over the hoop. But that was it. Was a nice rebound and attempt by Sophie, but she just missed the shot.
Yeah, there's a lot of banging around going under there. They're they could call more fouls.
We're only down by five, though, at the end of the first, so we're certainly still in the game.
I'm not calling for more fouls because they'll go against us.
Well, but, Andrews and, Pacus and Greenwood were tied up 10-10.
That's shocking to me.
At the end of the first quarter, Pacus has really improved. They won two games in a row at one point in the district.
Nice pass.
Oh, man, Ivana didn't take that shot. But there is Victoria Maldonado sinking the basket, and she'll be fouled.
Plus one.
So she'll have an extra opportunity for another free throw.
And just like that, we're within three. So really, congratulations to the defense. They've locked them down since the first quarter.
Well,
a little bit better, and we're scoring some.
And also, Darrell, that is the second foul on their best player, Kiki Morrison.
Well, they could have got her for another one as well.
Free throw brought to you by Rainwater Motor Company is no good. Ball goes out of bounds. It'll be Fort Stockton ball again. Andrews tips it out. All right, Lizeth Robles is in the game now. And I believe maybe Encinas came out, perhaps. Let me see. Yeah, Encinas came
Norman
out.
Norman came in.
And what do we got here? A turnover by the Prowlers? We might have stepped on the out-of-bounds line.
That's got to be frustrating to Coach Bishop.
Yep. 9-6 now. Andrews in the lead. We have outscored them 2-0 here in this quarter. There's a steal by Ivana Ortiz, but they're going to call it a tie ball.
Just as good as a steal.
And that's with Danley Fisher.
Well, they get the ball back, but that's a good stop for them.
All right, here's the inbounds play. This goes to Rondon. And Rondon has the ball knocked away by Victoria Maldonado. Good job by Maldonado coming up from behind her to knock that dribble away.
Yeah, good hustle there. They're not the same ball handling team with
without Morrison?
Without Morrison.
All right, here's Anae Mojia out front now. Mojia goes inside, and that's going to be a travel. They call a tie ball, and it's Fort Stockton ball. I guess maybe, we might have tied it up in midair, but you could have also called a travel, right?
It would have been a travel if it was us.
Yeah. 6:42 to go, second period. 9-6 is our score, and Andrews in the lead. We're in the second quarter. That's your Little Regina Trucking game score. And now here's a long shot taken by Ortiz. No good. Sophia with the putback. No good. Kimbri Norman makes a putback. And, Darryl, we were talking about offensive rebounds.
Uh-huh.
And there is a great example of that, how it pays off. We missed two shots, and then we got the third one to go down. Now we've got a one-point game, 9-8. Andrews in the lead with 6:14 to go.
I need to watch. What is number one for
Theata?
For Andrews.
That's Rondon.
She is throwing elbows all the way down the court.
All right, here's Rondon to inbound. It's Charlize.
Charlize
is her first name, yes. 6:14 to go, second period. It's a one-point ball game as we've outscored Andrews 4-0 here in the second period. Of course, we talked about Oh, there's a nice shot by number three, Tori Rodea for Andrews. That'll put them up by three now, 11-8. That is your Little Regina Trucking game score. Here's Lizeth Robles out front now for the Prowlers. And now Kimbri Norman. Here's Victoria Maldonado is going to be called for a travel. Okay. Maybe she shuffled her feet before she started dribbling.
I didn't see it, but.
Well, you're listening to our broadcast on KFST AM 860, KFST 94.3 FM. We've got it on KFSTradio.com, and we're streaming live with video and audio on Facebook and YouTube. All right, here's Andrews with Mojia, and there's a steal by Maldonado again. Maldonado goes to Wieslar, and she scores.
Beautiful, beautiful pass.
That was a nice fast break brought to you
Maldonado
by M&J Fast Lube. The Otto Wieslar scores, and it's a one-point game, 11-10, Andrews. Second quarter, Tori Rodea inbounds the ball to Rondon. Oh, that's going to be a foul, although might have been a little bit of an acting job as well. The Ottawa slot is called for the foul, knocking down the Andrews player. 11-10 is our score with Andrews in the lead. Here's Tori Rodea. Are those fouls right? I'm not sure they are.
For
on,
who?
On the board. I'm talking about the number of team fouls in this period. I don't think that's right. I think that's a leftover from the first quarter.
They probably haven't reset it.
All right, Lizeth Robles over to the Ottawa slot. And now to Maldonado. Here's Wieslar. Pass over to the right wing. This goes to Robles. We got a charging foul on Robles.
It is good acting now. That was really a poor call.
Well, that's Darren's favorite official.
Is that him?
That's him.
Well, he's I can see why.
Well, I think he worked with Darren at some point down in the past over in Midland. But anyway, there's a ball on the floor. Ball's going to go out of bounds. I believe it's going to be maybe Andrew's ball here. And we've got Kaylin Reeves coming back in for Maldonado here. 4.5 minutes to go, first half. 11-10, Andrews, and they will inbound. It'll be Charlize Rondon. You know, Seminole was shutting out Monahans. Seminole is leading Monahans 55-2 at halftime.
Well,
here's a three-pointer taken by Andrews. No good. Kimbri Norman with a nice rebound. And out to Robles. And we had Greenwood and Pecos. They were tied up 10-10 after the first quarter.
No update on them.
It's a must-win for Pecos tonight, Darrell. To make the playoffs, they've got to beat Greenwood. And Greenwood, of course, and Andrews are tied for second place, so it's really a very important game for Greenwood also.
Yeah, I'm surprised it was 10-10, but Pecos is getting better.
They are.
And I think if they win and we lose, we'll probably have a play-in game.
I would imagine. And that's okay because we need the practice.
I would rather us not have to play in.
And there's Kaylin Reeves taking a high pass. All right, here's Norman. Oh, bad pass. I don't know. It kind of went funny off of her hand, and it didn't.
They weren't on the same page, maybe.
Something. 3:37 left in the second quarter. One-point game here. Andrews on top, 11-10. 3:37 left in the second. Andrews passes it in to Rodea. She pivots, double-teamed in the backcourt. Now they bring it across. This is Tijerina. Now they try to work it in the lane, put up the shot. It's no good. And there's Amaya tying it up. And it will be Andrews' ball on the possession arrow. Amaya tied up that rebound, but Andrews gets the advantage here. Here they come with an inbounds play under their own baseline. And now it's Rodriguez, passes off to Rondon. 3:15 left in the second quarter. Andrews 11, Fort Stockton 10. Here's a floater by number one, Charlize Rondon. That's a nice shot.
Just a stop and a pop, and there's nothing we could do about it.
13-10, Andrews now after that good shot by Rondon. Nice breaking of the press
nice
that
pass.
Time, and oh darn it. I'll tell you, Norman just mishandled that pass. She was going to have a shot right there that probably would have gone in at point-blank range.
Beautiful pass from Caitlin Reeves.
Nice offensive play, but we fouled it up. Here's a little hook shot by Andrews in the lane. No good, but a foul called on Fort Stockton. Two shots at the free throw line coming for the Lady Mustangs. I think Amaya Urias is going to be called for her first foul.
Well, I'll take Darren's role here, too. They kind of bailed her out. She was not in control. She was throwing up a prayer.
Andrews with the free throw, and it is no good. I believe it's Colbath at the line, and she missed that one.
Colbath?
Well, Darren would go crazy on the boys' roster. They've got a McGruff on their roster.
Really?
Yeah.
Is he the crime dog?
Maybe. And that's another miss.
Oh,
a bad pass. And Andrews picks it off. They put up a wild shot. It's no good. Andrews still has the ball after a rebound. They miss another one off the back iron, and Amaya Urias finally comes away with the rebound. We got a break there. And here comes Reeves going to
good.
Be. No, it's – yeah, it is Reeves.
It's Reeves, yeah.
Going to be fouled, and she'll have two shots at the line. Number three, Tori Rodea, call for the foul. And here we have Rainwater Motor Company free throws for the Prowlers. You know, Darryl, this is only our second free throw of the whole game.
Yeah, and we've, you know, been called for everything there is, and it's amazing that they get called for hardly anything.
And that is short, no good. Kaylin Reeves with another free throw attempt brought to you by Rainwater Motor Company.
Top to bottom, the whole program, we need to be better free throw shooters.
And nice. That shot is good. Brought to you by Rainwater Motor Company.
As all bad right. as our start was, this is pretty tight right now.
All right, Andrews in the backcourt in danger of a 10-second violation, but they get it across. And that's a wild shot. No good. Rebound picked up by Ortiz. And now we just try to get that fast break going, but it wasn't. We weren't positioned quite well, and they were down on defense, and we turned it over.
There's a time to be patient on those, and I think that was a good example of it.
Here's Andrews. Tijerina goes to the right corner. Nice defense there by Amaya to deny a three attempt. Rondon out front. We've got a minute 33 left in the second. They're at the top of the key. Dribble around. They dribble inside. Turned away by Reeves. That's another good defensive play. Rondon now back out front. They're pretty patient on offense at times. Here's the shot off the back iron. No good. Rebound. Nice one by Reeves. All right, here comes the Ottawa slot for the Prowlers with a minute five.
Two-point game.
Yep.
13-11.
13-11. The Lady Mustangs leading. Here's Amaya out front now. Long pass in the corner. Kaylin with a three. In and out. No good. And that's, Andrews with the rebound.
I like the shot, though. That's good.
I do. That was close. It was a triple R welding three-point shot attempt, but missed. 40 seconds now. Here's a long three-pointer by Andrews.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, boy. Kasim Tijerina makes that three, and that makes it all of a sudden a little bit of a different ball game here before halftime. But let's try to match them here. Oh, that's a travel or a turnover against the Prowlers. I think we touched the baseline before the travel. 23 seconds. We've not had a good ending to this second quarter.
No.
Even
the three-pointer, she shot it from her waist. If there was anybody out there close to her, I don't think.
And she was about 3 feet beyond the arc.
Yeah.
There's another three. That one is no good. And the rebound tied up between Ortiz and Rodea. 10 seconds now is all we have left in this second quarter. It's a five-point lead by Andrews, 16-11. And here come the Prowlers with the Ottawa slot. We go to Kalen Reeves now. Reeves is all covered up. Got to shoot. We did not. It's 16-11 Andrews at halftime. We'll be back in just a moment.
Concept Inc. is here to help you with all your oil field and residential needs. They provide licensed septic system installations, site evaluations, roll-off container rentals, and porta-potty rentals, septic tank and grease trap pump-outs. Backhoe services and general construction also available. Contact Kobe Tarasas at 432-290-3620. That phone number again is 432-290-3620. Concept Inc. Contessa Ready Mix is now open and ready to serve all your concrete needs. They also offer general construction, precast, material hauling, and sand and gravel. They're located at 2270 Gonzales Loop. For more information, call 432-290-4947. Contessa Ready Mix, owned and operated by Colby Tarasas, serving Fort Stockton and the surrounding area.
Mesitos de Azucar is a great local bakery at 302 East Dickinson, now open every day, including Monday through Friday, 6:30 a.m. till 6 p.m., Saturday, 7:30 a.m. to 8 p.m., and Sundays, 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. They offer pastries and cookies, sweetbreads, lunch and breakfast served all day, and sandwiches are served on their delicious fresh bread. You can also buy bread loaves by the dozen. Visit the Facebook page of Mesitos de Azucar for new items. They have menudo, tortas, caldos, and all kinds of breakfast and lunch sandwiches. Mesitos de Azucar at 302 East Dickinson.
Once upon a time, a person's banker knew them by name. They saw their banker as a partner, a resource, and even a friend. Bankers used to do more than hold your money and process your checks. Bankers used to help you build your dreams. At First National Bank of Fort Stockton, we offer you that kind of banking again. For buying, building, or remodeling a home, for commercial banking, for personal banking from your first checking account to the last bank you will ever need. The First National Bank of Fort Stockton, member FDIC, equal housing lender. NMLS number 410651.
Fort Stockton ISD Public Schools shape the future by providing the best possible education for our students. Hello, this is Dr. Gabe Zamora, superintendent. Together we are ensuring that the future of our community, state, and nation is bright. Fort Stockton ISD is committed to bettering the future for all members of our school community. We are extremely proud of all our students and their accomplishments. For this reason, we are pleased to sponsor Fort Stockton High School sports broadcasts for those unable to attend. Go Panthers and Prowlers!
Are your insurance rates too high? At Fort Stockton Insurance, you're not stuck. We can shop within our own carriers to find the best deals. Do you know that we do more than property and auto? We do life, commercial, farm, and specialty insurance. Do you want to run on the field with the Baylor Bears, have an Aerolite plane or a vintage vehicle? We insure all of that. Need a bond or commercial insurance? We can help you there too. This is Pam at Fort Stockton Insurance. We're located at 901 West Dickinson or give us a call at 336-8565.
The Guadalajara Mexican Grill in Fort Stockton features authentic Jalisco-style Mexican food with friendly and fast service. They're open starting at 8 a.m. for breakfast daily until 9:30 each night, Tuesday through Thursday, and until 10 p.m. Friday through Sunday. They also feature delicious Mexican desserts, along with beer, pina coladas, margaritas, and micheladas, with great specials every day. The Guadalajara Mexican Grill at 200 East 19th in Fort Stockton on the Imperial Highway. Hernandez Sanitation in Fort Stockton proudly serves a large portion of West Texas with sanitation services, including the oil field. For portable toilets, holding tanks, septic tank service, grease trap service, or large roll-off trash containers, contact Hernandez Sanitation today by calling owner and operator Joe Angel Hernandez at 432-336-3803. Hernandez Sanitation, a proud member of the Fort Stockton community, always supporting all the athletic and extracurricular activities in Fort Stockton schools. In times of need, trust Heritage Funeral Home of the Big Bend, your compassionate partner in honoring cherished memories. We encourage you to visit us, where our caring and experienced team will guide you through budget-friendly ways to pay tribute to your loved ones. As a family-owned and operated establishment, we've been Fort Stockton's trusted funeral home for many years, dedicated to serving our community with empathy and understanding. Come experience the heartfelt difference at Heritage Funeral Home of the Big Bend, where family matters most.
Do Julie's Easy Press Cleaners is ready to serve you with all your laundry cleaning needs, from drop-off to pick-up. You'll enjoy not having to do the washing, drying, or pressing. It's done for you. Whether it's a party, office meeting, or lunch with friends, show up dressed for success. Because at Julie's Easy Press, they know when you look good, you feel good. Julie's Easy Press, 1101 North Front Street, or call 336-6601.
At K-Bob Steakhouse in Fort Stockton, we pride ourselves on great food, great service, and great atmosphere. We work hard every day to make sure that every trip to K-Bob's is worth your time. Whether it's lunch with friends, a family dinner, or a special occasion, K-Bob's is always here to serve you the food America loves. K-Bob Steakhouse, Fort Stockton, 2800 West Dickinson.
All right, we're back at halftime. Let's take a look at some stats. Andrews outscored us 9-4 in that first quarter, and then we had even scoring in the second quarter, 7-7. We started out outscoring Andrews, I believe, 4-0 in that second quarter, but Andrews made that three near the end of the second quarter. That helped them out a lot, but we're still very much in this game, down by only 5 points, Darrell. It just seems like our shots have not been falling, and we've had too many turnovers. But our offensive rebounding was looking a little better in the second quarter.
Yeah, I think the rebounding was better. Even the late turnovers in the second quarter, it was us pressing. It wasn't I don't think that we had to go down as fast as we were trying. And sometimes it's better just to pull it back and make sure you get a possession.
Well, you need to just have passes that – will not be intercepted, obviously, by Andrews. That's the key. But we did that too many times. Yeah, we're trying to make something happen on offense, but sometimes, it's not a good idea.
Yeah, if it's not there, it's not there.
It's not there, that's right.
We're only 5 points out. We're
right
in the game. As bad as we started, this is certainly a game that I think we can come back and win it, and I'm looking forward to a great second half.
All right. Charlize Rondon has 2 points for Andrews. Tori Rodea has two. Kiki Morrison has seven. She got two fouls in that first quarter and was taken out. I'm sure we'll see her a lot in the second half. Cassine Tijerina with three. Allie Fulford with two, and they're 1 out of 3 from the line tonight. But Kiki Morrison is one of their key players, and, you know, she missed, I think, the entire second quarter. Theodore Slod with 2 points for us. Amaya Urias has two. Victoria Maldonado has two. Alondra Encinas has two. Kimberly Norman has two. Caitlin Reeves with one. And we shot 1 out of 3 from the line. So we didn't have anybody, in the major scoring column, but we did have several players getting a basket.
It's good to see. Yeah, it's good to see it spread out. It keeps it from having to – or from guarding one. And that's what we need to do with Kiki Morrison. We need to figure out a way to shut her down, and I think we're staying in the game.
Well, Seminole has already clinched the district championship at 9-0. Greenwood and Andrews are tied at 6-3 for second place. That's why this game and the Greenwood-Pecos game is so important tonight. And so they're both 6-3. Fort Stockton's in fourth place at 3-6. Pecos in fifth place at 2-7. And, they had a strong surge at the end of the second half of district play. They beat Monahans and Fort Stockton, and so they have improved. And Monahans is 1-8. Their one victory is over Pecos. So tonight it's going to be big, this Greenwood versus Pecos game, and the Andrews Fort Stockton game. Going to be big.
It's a big game. As we mentioned earlier, if Pecos wins that, we're in a play-in game with them.
Yep, I think so.
And maybe that may not be bad, because I think we get Canyon after that. So
Greenwood leading Pecos 18-16 at halftime. The Maidens of Seminole leading Monahans 55-2 at halftime.
If you've paid any attention at all, Seminole is the class of the district.
Yeah.
I was even surprised last, I guess it would have been Friday, that Greenwood played them what we would call fairly close. It was still 60-something to 20-something.
Well, it was more than that. I think that was a third quarter score.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, we'll be back in just a moment.
M&J Trucking in Fort Stockton is proud to be a sponsor of Panther and Prowler Sports. M&J Trucking offers 24-hour-a-day, 7-day-a-week service. Call today for information at 336-8866. M&J Trucking, located at 3300 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton. Proud supporters of the Fort Stockton Panthers and Prowlers.
Sawyer Insurance Agency has 6 locations in West Texas to serve you, including 706 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton and 1502 South Stockton Avenue in Monahans, along with offices in Pecos, Midland, Lubbock, and Amarillo. They offer the most complete line of commercial and personal insurance, from workers' comp, general liability, business and personal auto, commercial property, equipment, oil and gas, farm and ranch, and home insurance. Contact Clyde, Nathan, or Travis Sawyer today by calling 336-7543 or 943-9600.
All right, we're back with more Prowler basketball starting the third quarter. The Prowlers are down by 5 points, 16-11. That is your game score, brought to you by Little Regina Trucking. Our free throws brought to you by Rainwater Motor Company. Our forced turnovers brought to you by M&J Trucking. Our fast breaks brought to you by M&J Fast Lube. Three-point shooting appropriately by Triple R Welding. Game score by Little Regina Trucking. Timeouts by R&K Rentals and Party Supplies. Thanks to all of our sponsors for making Prowler and Panther basketball possible. We don't have many games left.
Not many. I was just looking there. Two best players both have 2 fouls. We need to see what we can do about getting them in foul trouble.
Well, guess what? Morrison's back in the game. She is quick and a good ball handler. She makes a difference for this Andrews team. Allie Fulford now out front, just holding the ball. Now dribbles over to the left side. And we're going to have a foul right away on Amaya Urias on the wrist of the shooter.
They said she was shooting, I guess.
Yep,
so
they're going to give her 2 shots at the free throw line.
They, if they get near the basket, they're chunking it. And that's something I think we could learn from, is if you're near it, chunk it, probably get a foul.
All right, that free throw is good by Andrews, and Fulford increases their lead to 6 points. Fulford again at the line. Andrews, even though they're in the northern section, you know, of West Texas, or our area at least, she misses that second one. Here's an intercepted ball by Morrison, and here she comes. But, Darren, they're not the quality of the programs of way up north in the Panhandle.
No. Tell me about the Canyon District.
Oh, they're excellent.
Yeah.
The fourth
but
place.
It's the three Canyon schools, and who else? Perryton?
Pampa, I believe.
Okay.
Allie Fulford hands it off to Morrison. I believe Seminole is going to get Pampa in the playoffs, and that is a 3-pointer by Morrison missed. And it's Amaya with the rebound, and to Theodore we slot. And Pampa's no pushover. I mean, they're good.
Right.
All those teams are good.
Well, our district needs to shape up and become more competitive. And
yeah, we do.
Catch up with Seminole so that we can compete with those schools up there.
Amaya Urias out front. And now to Ivana Ortiz. I thought she was going to shoot. Did not. And see, there we go.
Just
with
forcing it.
You see, because of the not taking the shot there, we didn't get one.
Right.
And we should have taken the shot when we had the chance.
Had an open shot, and then we tried to force it to a player that really wasn't open.
That's right. And we turned it over. So it's 17-11. Andrews up by 6. Here's Morrison dribbling on the right wing. Now they try to go inside. Oh, what a nice defensive play by Amaya Urias, tipping that ball to her teammate, Ivana Ortiz. It's a nice defensive job by Amaya.
Well, they tried to force it in.
Here's Kimbry. And there's a nice play inside, but that's a travel on Ivana. Couldn't quite get her feet stopped, as she was really on the run when she got that ball.
To me, it looked like Kimbry could have just turned around and taken a shot at the free throw line.
There's one of our seniors down there, and I was talking to her before the game. They're selling some sunglasses for the student council, and she's going to go to the University of Texas, I think, at Austin. Very proud of her for that.
Yeah, good.
I told her, don't be scared. Do it. It's a kind of – it can be a scary place.
Yeah, so we've got –
what do we have, a foul? Who do we have
foul
a foul?
Was on
– Theodore Wieslot.
Theodore.
That's an in-and-out shot on the free throw by Rondon.
She just gets over there and just throws the ball up, and it causes the foul.
Here's Rondon with another free throw for Andrews. They're leading by six now. We have not scored in the third quarter. Here's the shot. It's good. Now they've outscored us 2-0 in the quarter. Makes it an 18-11 lead for Andrews. Here comes the Ottawa slot. Broke out of that defensive.
There you go.
Clog right
there.
That's
three on number 32. For
number 32, that's Allie Fulford, their 5'10 junior center, who's just been called for her third foul.
That's kind of what we need to do. Is she drove the ball, she got close to the basket, she threw it up, probably wasn't going to go in, but they called the foul on her, and now they're big girls out.
And a Rainwater Motor Company free throw is no good. The Ottawa slot goes to the line again. Here's another Rainwater Motor Company free throw.
Nice.
That one is good. First points that we've scored in the third quarter in the first couple of minutes here of this period. Charlize Rondon brings it down the left sideline. Morrison has played without any fouls here in this third period so far.
She's right. So aggressive. She's going to foul if you get position on her.
All right, here's a pass to Rodriguez. Back over to Morrison. Tries to penetrate inside, cut off. And that is another nice defensive play by Amaya Urias and tipping it out of bounds. And they tried to go to their big post, Carly Colbath, and Amaya's doing a good job on her.
Amaya, really good defense right there.
All right, here's the inbounds play by Colbath to Morrison, right corner. And now Morrison switches hands with the dribble, tries to go inside. Cut off by Ivana. That's a nice defensive job by Ivana as well. All right, here's Morrison again. And we've got to create some turnovers, however, Darrell.
We need some turnovers or just good stops. And
here's Rondon in the lane. Ball picked off, and it's picked up again by Morrison. She goes to the hoop. It's in and out, no good. Morrison puts it back up. It's no good. And it will be out of bounds.
There's a stop. Good
on
job,
Andrews.
Yeah.
Boy, they held the ball, though, for a long time. 18-12, Andrews leading by six. That is your Little Regina Trucking game score. And now there's Kaylin Reeves inbounding. Fast break down to Ivana. And the defenders are down, so that's a
good
wise
stop,
decision
to hold it up.
All right, here's Alondra Encinas now. Top of the key. Now back to Wieslot. The lane is wide open at this point.
It's wide open, but we have a hard time penetrating.
Oh, and there is Victoria Maldonado had a chance at a layup, but it was knocked out of her hands by Morrison. Now we got a foul on Andrews.
Number 11, that's what he said.
That'd be Colbath.
Colbath.
Yep, that is her. She's the one called. So now Theata will be inbounding the ball.
They should bring her a rubber ducky.
Kaylin Reeves hits the side of the backboard with that shot. And Kiki Morrison almost loses the ball.
She's fast.
She is fast. Yep. Oh, there's wide open in the lane, but they miss a point-blank shot by Dana Rodriguez. Ivana Ortiz now holding it up. Here's a three by Reeves. Oh, it's no good. It's off to the right. Andrews gets the rebound. I like the three shot, though.
I like it.
It's a triple R welding three-point attempt. No good.
You just have to remember, I try to tell my grandkids, long shots make long rebounds.
Yeah.
And you can't get too far underneath.
And here's Morrison. Thought about a three. Did not take it. T. Harina now for Andrews. They work it inside in the lane.
She traveled.
She did. She took an extra step. We get the rebound after a missed shot. Here comes Ivana Ortiz down the center. And here's Kaylin Reeves. They found her wide open on the other side of the basket. And that's a nice assist. And Fort Stockton gets the shot by Reeves. It's now a four-point game, 18-14. Andrews on top. Finally, we get a basket. There's
and
a turnover
steal
by Encinas. Reeves with a fast break again, and we've got a foul on Andrews. This will be two shots coming for Reeves. This is on number 10, I believe, Tijerina. That's
yes,
her first.
Tijerina. And good little run by Fort Stockton here.
Reeves at the free throw line with a Rainwater Motor Company free throw. We need these.
We need them.
Here's the first free throw by Reeves. Short, no good. You can see that when it came out of her hand. Reeves again with another free throw. Let's make this one. It's brought to you by Rainwater Motor Company. Reeves just a freshman. The shot is no good. Short again. Two short shots. Andrews with the rebound.
Harassing him a little bit.
All right. We apply some backcourt pressure. Here's Andrews with it. Rondon out at the top of the key. 2:30 remaining in this third period. Andrews is on top, 18-14. They need to keep pace with Greenwood, of course, to tie them for second place if Greenwood wins tonight, by the way.
And difference 22nd and third can be huge when you're playing north.
Oh, yeah. Kiki Morrison out front, now to Rondon.
Good defense.
Right wing. And they go back out front to Rodriguez. Andrews is very patient on offense. There is a lay-in attempt. That's an elbow thrown by somebody. Oh, they're going to call it on Morrison, if I'm not mistaken. Or did they call it on us?
They called it on us, but he gave the wrong number because there's not a five on the floor.
Yeah, there is.
Ivana
Ortiz. But, see, Morrison's five, and so is Ortiz. All right, here's Morrison at the free throw line. Shot is no good.
I like their offense. They drive to the basket and put it up. And a lot of good things happen, even if you don't even make a shot.
Two new players come in for each team. I believe Robles and Sophie Hernandez come in for the Prowlers. Here's Morrison at the line. Shot is no good again.
I think I found something she doesn't do well.
Well, they're not shooting very well as a team on free throws. And here is Sophie Hernandez.
She was down here by herself, but the pass was so far away from the basket, she didn't get a chance.
Wow, that is a nice shot by Kaylin Reeves. She's fouled on the way in, so she's going to get two.
Just doing what Andrews does. She got close and put it up and gets fouled.
Yep.
Good things happen when you shoot.
I believe it was on Dana Rodriguez, number 15.
They just credited her with the.
All right, here is Reeves. That's a good free throw after she had missed a couple. That's a Rainwater Motor Company free throw. Good. Now we've closed it to a three-point game. Kaylin Reeves at the line again. And here's her shot. And it's off the back iron, no good. Victoria Maldonado with the rebound. Now Sophie Hernandez to Robles. And here's Wieslaw. Oh, that was a collision of two Fort Stockton players, and it results in a travel. We ran into each other. 18.
I've noticed sometimes on the weave, it's not really a smooth transition.
18-15 is our score. Andrews on top with a minute 34. I believe it was a five-point game at halftime. And here's Morrison. Goes inside, and her shot is good. That's a nice one by Morrison. Her first basket of the second half. Timeout on the court. And this R&K Reynolds and Party Supplies timeout. We'll be back in a moment.
Do you need dirt work done, trash hauling, roll-off dumpsters, a location built, line locating? Well, then look no further than Little Regina Trucking. They do it all and offer very reasonable prices, too. Stop by at 701 North Rooney or call 432-250-9611 7 days a week, 24 hours a day. Little Regina Trucking. We'll get it done.
Fort Mickey's Ice House in Fort Stockton is the place to get your drinks and snacks in Fort Stockton, with two convenient drive-through lanes open 7 days a week for teas, lemonades, and fountain drinks with added flavors upon request and much more. Go by Porky's Ice House, and remember, happy hour is each day from 4 to 6 p.m. with all drinks any size for just a dollar. They also make popular Clamato, Squirt, Topo Chico, and Jerky Preparados that are delicious, along with nachos. Porky's Ice House, 1401 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton.
All right, we're back at third quarter action here with Fort Stockton trailing the Andrews Lady Mustangs right now 20-15. Daryl, our offense has not been stellar tonight, that's for sure. We only scored 4 points in the first, 7 points in the second, and we've scored 4 points so far here in the third. So we really need to get our offense, moving.
Yeah, we, there's, three times we pulled within two or three, and then we let them pull back away. So, but still 5 points, this couple of baskets takes care of a lot of ills.
Well, we got beat by Andrews by 8 points at their place. There's a long pass down to Amaya, and then we throw it away.
Once again, a little patience does wonders there.
Just a bad pass.
Yeah.
Right in between two Andrews players, and they pick it off. And Andrews takes so much time on offense, Daryl. They possess the ball a lot of the clock. And so sometimes there's a block shot by Kaylin Reeves, and she misses. It's a nice block by Kaylin off of Morrison's shot, and we get the rebound. Here we go. There's Lizeth Robles, and now here's Amaya out front. Changed up her offense a little bit now, Daryl. And here's Reeves with a three. It is no good off the back iron. Andrews with a nice rebound.
It was an open shot. I mean, it's
I like the shot.
She traveled.
That's a travel on Morrison. Yep. And harassment there by Theodore Slott. 20-15 our score. That's your Little Regina Trucking game score. And it's Andrews on top by five, third quarter with only 24 seconds. Here's the Ottawa slot. We need to get a shot off. Remember, in the second first half, we did not get a shot off in time?
Yes, I remember.
And here we are again. Here's Theata with a point-blank shot, and it's a basket. Good for Theata. Now we're down by three, and here's Andrews missing a shot at the buzzer. Andrews 20, Fort Stockton 17 at the end of the third quarter. That's your Little Regina Trucking game score. Now we take an R&K Reynolds and Party Supplies timeout.
Need a quick, efficient oil change? M&J Fast Lube at 116 West Dickinson is here to serve you. Martine and Julia Ibarra invite you to stop by. They have great service, and they offer auto oil and lube services with the top major oil brands. They also offer state inspections and vehicle washing and cleaning, or you can get your vehicle completely detailed. It'll look like you just bought it. That's M&J Fast Lube, 116 West Dickinson, supporting Panther and Prowler Sports. Go Blue!
Stockton Glass and Mirror is locally owned and operated and welcomes you to give them a call for a free estimate on any job. They're your premier commercial and residential glass installation company, proudly serving the Trans-Pecos and Big Bend for more than 30 years. Stockton Glass and Mirror offers quality glass products professionally installed, along with broken glass repair, shower enclosures, and much more. Open Monday through Friday, 8 to noon and 1 to 5. Call 336-3152 or go by 202 East 5th Street. Stockton Glass and Mirror, glass west of the Pecos.
Triple R Welding is here to serve you. You design it, they can build it. You have a job that needs to be done, they can do it. Offering hotshot services, welding, inspections, roustabout services. They're oil field certified. Battery and SWD construction offered. They have heavy equipment rentals and lots more. Call for a quote at 336-5289 or stop by at 2215 West 9th Street. Triple R Welding, they can complete your job in a timely and cost-efficient manner. Call 336-5289.
As we come back to play, Daryl, we start the fourth quarter, and we got the ball, but we just turned it over on a bad pass, out of bounds on the sideline on our end of the court.
Not even close.
No.
We're still within three, and every time we've gotten within three, they've pulled away, so we need to make a stop right here.
Kiki Morrison with the ball out front for Andrews. Like I said several times, they take so much time on offense, it limits our possessions.
There's a good.
That's a tie-up. Well, that was a quick tie-up call by the ref, and Victoria Maldonado got in there for the tie, but Andrews has the possession arrow with Rodea inbounding. We're down only by three, 20-17. That's your Little Regina Trucking game score. Andrews on top. Andrews got the inbounds play. That's a travel or a double dribble.
Yeah.
Double dribble on Morrison.
That's a second turnover in her in the last minute or two.
Lizeth Robles will inbound. All right, Robles inbounding to Ortiz. Back to Ortiz. We're having a little bit of trouble getting it up the court here. Maldonado out to Wieslaud. And now Maldonado shoots the open shot. It's good.
Good job with run.
That was a nice job there finding Maldonado open. And that makes it a one-point game. The Prowlers are down 20-19.
Morrison. She traveled again.
She traveled, and they didn't call it. Mojia out to Morrison again. Didn't you think that was a travel?
I thought it was she carried it. She had a suitcase with her.
Yep. Mojia, the open jumper, no good. Nice reach in for that rebound by Robles. And now a foul on Andrews, I think. That's on Dana Rodriguez, number 15, I believe.
Andrews may be feeling a little bit of pressure here. I think they thought they'd be maybe ahead of us by more.
Here we go with the inbounds play. Lizeth Robles with 6:38 to go here in the fourth quarter. Fort Stockton having some trouble again getting it up the court here. And we do get it across. Nice job there by Ivana Ortiz. Here's Robles now out front. It's got to wear them down a little bit, Darrell, playing that full court pressure all the time.
Yeah.
Here is a three by Wieslaud. It's no good. And the rebound by Fort Stockton. Here's another three put up by Ivana. No good. Ivana got another offensive rebound. I like these threes, although we haven't made the last two. But you know what? I like the try.
Well, you're usually in good shape for rebounds when you make shoot a three and don't make it.
And here's Ortiz. Wieslaud in the corner. Goes in for a short shot. Floater is no good. The rebound, good job by Encinas. Her shot no good. And now we got a foul over the back on Andrews.
On Reardon. Rondon.
Yeah, that's on Rondon. It's her first, I believe. How many team fouls? Four on each team? I don't know if that's...
No, I think there's two on them, and that's it.
Here's the inbounds play. Beautiful to Maldonado. And look at that, Darrell. The Prowlers have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter, 21-20. And that is your Little Regina Trucking game score. Now Andrews on the right wing to Rondon. And here's Morrison back out to the three-point line. Oh, it's good by number 10, Cassine Tijerina. That's her second three-pointer of the night. And now the ball is loose, and Andrews is going to come.
Yeah.
We threw it away there. And Andrews, here they come down the court. They've taken back the lead over the Prowlers, 23-21.
I know they want to be aggressive, but we don't even get a shot on those. You've got to be patient.
Here's Morrison out front. Andrews with a two-point lead, 23-21. I thought it would be close here tonight at our court. Here's Morrison shooting the long jumper. That's no good. And Andrews got an offensive rebound by Colbath. We need to get those rebounds. 4:35 to go. Andrews on top by two. 23-21. That's your Little Regina Trucking game score. Andrews has the pass blocked, but they get the ball back again with Tijerina. They work it inside. They miss a shot inside. And finally, we get a rebound by Ortiz.
Good stop for Fort Stockton. Now we need to be patient here.
And here come the Prowlers. Good job there by Ivana. Dribble it down across midcourt and then hold up.
Let your team catch up.
Yep. Because she had four defenders on her. All right, here's Encinas to Maldonado. Sets a screen. Now a three put up. Oh, it's off the glass and no good by Lizeth Robles. Now we got a foul on the Prowlers.
I think it's in Encinas. We'll see.
Yeah, I think so. Encinas. And Andrews will inbound. They're not in the bonus yet. 3:52 to go, fourth quarter. Neither team has shot well from the free throw line tonight. It's a two-point lead by Andrews, 23-21, 3:50 to go in the ball game now. We're in the fourth quarter. Almost a steal by Theodora, but Andrews controls it. They go to the left wing, left corner. A three put up, short, no good. Balls is out of bounds. It'll be Encinas last touching it. So Andrews will get the ball on their own baseline.
Ball came off hard off the rim, and she just wasn't ready to catch it. They don't really. Their three-point shooting's the difference in the game. I think they've hit three maybe or two, and we're not able to knock them down, but we're going to get hot here.
6 points, yeah. Two threes by T. Harina. That's what they have. And we have had no three-point shots tonight. There's a tie-up. I mean, that should have been a tie-up. We've got a timeout called by Coach Bishop, I believe. That is an R&K Reynoldson Party Supplies timeout. We'll be back in a moment.
If you're needing personal attention to your medical needs, visit Salceda Urgent Care and Family Medicine in Fort Stockton at 703 North Main. They can help with life's little urgencies that cannot wait for an appointment. They provide urgent care, hormone optimization for men and women, vitamin supplements, family medicine, chronic care for all ages, including cholesterol treatment, blood pressure, diabetes, thyroid optimization, and treat many other conditions. Call for appointments 360-3029. Walk-ins are welcome at 703 North Main. Wheats Tire Incorporated is your family-owned and operated tire store serving Fort Stockton in West Texas for over 35 years with a friendly staff and unparalleled customer service. They're your authorized Firestone and Bridgestone tire dealer, but offer many brands, most in stock. They offer speedy repair and tire installation with wheel balancing and alignment along with rotations. They can also do brake jobs and other minor auto repair. Go by Wheats Tire today at 701 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton or call 432-336-3314.
All right, we're back. Andrews has the ball, and we're going to have another foul
like
called on Fort Stockton.
That was not a good call.
This is on Ivana Ortiz, her third foul. And it sends Andrews to the free throw line. They lead it 23-21, just 3:17 left in this game.
Well, good. She missed it.
Missed the free throw. Is that Fisher at the line? I can't
that
tell.
Is number 13.
No, there's no 13. It's
well,
either
23 then.
It's either Fisher or Rodea. They
should make her cut her hair.
Yeah. All right, there's Fisher making one out of two. Increases the Andrews lead now to 24-21. All right, here is Lizeth Robles now. Out front for the Prowlers. Hands it off to Wieslaw. Wieslaw goes to Maldonado, left wing. Now to Norman out front. Reeves penetrates inside. Looked like she was fouled. And there is Reeves putting it back after an offensive rebound. And Andrews touched the baseline. It'll be Fort Stockton ball, I believe. 2:49 to go in the game. Three-point lead by Andrews.
I like the penetration. I think that we need to do more of that.
Wieslaw inbounding the ball to Norman, and they almost picked it off, but we got it back with Robles getting quickly to the ball. 2:40 to go. Andrews on top, 24-21. Wieslaw was bumped. Boy, and that was a bad pass.
How in the world did we catch that?
We're lucky we didn't turn it over. Andrews is getting in those passing lanes. Maldonado going to the free throw line, putting up the shot. It's no good. Reeves will tie it up on the rebound with Carly Colbath. And we get it back again on the possession arrow. 2:18 to go in this game. It's not like we haven't had some shots here on this possession.
We've had
some
shots. We just haven't made them down. That's
Reeves with a three. No good off the back iron. And there's Wieslaw with a rebound. That's a foul on number 10. Finally, we get a call. As T. Harina's called for the foul.
She was almost had a saddle on her, riding her out to the half-court line.
Now they've reset the team fouls. Andrews has three. We have four in the fourth quarter. All right, here's the inbounds play. Goes to Wieslot. We got to find a way to score, Darrell.
We need to score.
Andrews on top, 24-21. Low scoring ball game. Reeves puts up a shot.
Yeah, I thought she was fouled.
Yeah. Now, they're going to call a foul on Carly Colbath, yeah. Number 11. So this will be Reeves going to the free throw line.
Kind of a delayed call. To me, it looked like they were just going to call it out of bounds. But
Reeves is 2 out of 6 from the line tonight. This is a Rainwater Motor Company free throw. And it is good.
Good.
Yes.
Good, good.
And Reeves will get another one.
Come on, Caitlin, one more.
Just a freshman, and here she is. Another Rainwater Motor Company free throw. It's no good. Off the back iron, Andrews with the rebound, but a reach-in tie by Victoria Maldonado.
Victoria's scrappy. She is always around the ball.
It's a two-point game, 24-22. Andrews on top with just a minute 54 left. This is a big game. Here's the inbounds play to Morrison. We don't have any scoring updates from Pecos. We do, however. That ball goes out of bounds. It'll be Prowler ball.
Good defensive stand.
Seminole defeated Monahans tonight 103-12. So Seminole goes to 10-0 in district. Monahans at 1-9.
How many games did they score over 100?
I'm not sure, but Victoria has the ball knocked away from her. Morrison comes away with it. That's a carrying the ball on Morrison after the steal.
Yeah. Yep.
So she will turn it over with sort of an out-of-control dribble, but she did steal it away.
I thought they weren't going to call it.
Timeout by Fort Stockton, and we'll take this R&K Rentals and Party Supplies timeout. Be right back.
Looking for home cooking away from home? Sagebrush Cafe at 2003 West Dickinson is your answer. Mondays, try their chicken fried steak special for only $6.99. Tuesdays, it's the specialty burger and fries and wings special Wednesday. They serve the best breakfast around and they serve it all day long. Sagebrush Cafe offers many other menu items like catfish, salads, and Mexican food also. Sagebrush Cafe, 2003 West Dickinson for home cooked food away from home.
Permian Basin Abstract Company is located at 600 West Dickinson and is available to handle all your real estate closings. They have a full-service title company and are experts at handling all the tricky parts of title work. Great customer service is their number one goal with local manager Penny McKnight. Permian Basin Abstract has locations in Andrews, Seminole, Pecos, and the local office in Fort Stockton to serve all area West Texas counties and have all records available. Call 432-336-3301 or go by Permian Basin Abstract, corner of Monahans Highway and Dickinson Boulevard.
Well, we're back after a timeout, and we've got a big, big game here tonight between Fort Stockton and Andrews on our court. If we win, of course, we'll clinch a playoff spot.
Yes, that's what we need to do.
Yeah, and if Andrews loses, they would possibly fall to third place. So it's a big game for both teams. Kaylin Reeves will inbound the ball for the Prowlers to Maldonado. Here's Maldonado being guarded by Morrison. Wieslot. We've got a two-point deficit. Here's Norman shooting. Scoring! Kimbri Norman makes the shot. And, Darrell, I like to think that that's going to give us momentum toward the end here to win this game.
Well, that shot's been open for her, and she can knock it down.
All right, here is Andrews with T. Harina. They go inside, put the shot up off the glass. They answer with a bucket by Fulford.
Oh, good.
And the Prowlers will be fouled on the other end on a fast break brought to you by M&J Fast Lube.
And that's 4 on her.
4 on which one?
That's on Fulford.
Fulford.
Yeah. Yep.
Fourth foul on Fulford. Looks like she might have injured, maybe have a busted lip or a bloody nose. I'm not sure, but she was knocked pretty hard to the ground. But she fouled Norman on the way in for a layup. Yeah. Norman, what a huge shot a moment ago. But then Fulford came down and answered right back to give Andrews a two-point lead again, 26-24.
Yeah, she's matched up there against Norman underneath, and she's, what, 2-3 inches taller? She's a tall girl and got some skill.
Here's Kimberly Norman, Rainwater Motor Company free throws. First one good by Norman. And that puts the Prowlers within 1 point. We've got a timeout. Andrews will be back after this R&K Rentals and Party Supplies timeout.
Doctors Josh Pass, Brian Cherry, and Hewlin Pass are optometrists serving the West Texas area. Visit West Texas Eye Care at 605 North Main in Fort Stockton or 611 South Oak in Pecos. They offer complete and thorough eye examinations for the whole family, including therapeutic optometry, eyeglasses, contact lenses, laser surgery consultation, and screenings for macular degeneration and diabetes with an in-office lab. Call to make an appointment today in Fort Stockton at 336-3662 or in Pecos 445-3662.
This is Dakota Livesay for the Pecos County State Bank. The ethic of West Texas is one of dedication. Hard work, chin up, get it done. Long hours and extra effort always pays off in the long run. At the Pecos County State Bank, you will find employees who will do what it takes to make sure you are satisfied. You will find dedication, a West Texas institution since 1928. The Pecos County State Bank, all the bank you'll ever need. Member FDIC.
All right, Darrell, we're back, and we've just found out that Greenwood has defeated Pecos tonight 45-28. So they pulled away in the second half. And so that means that Fort Stockton has clinched a playoff spot even before the end of this game. How about that?
Yeah, it's and we get rewarded with Canyon.
That's true.
But all that's right. Okay.
Yeah. Kimberly Norman at the free throw line, second free throw. This could tie the game. Rainwater Motor Company free throw. Here's the shot. Ooh. It's in and out, no good. Rebound goes out. And
Fort Stockton ball.
45 seconds left. The Ottawa Slaughter to inbound the ball. We trail by one. Got a timeout. And we'll take this R&K Rentals and Party Supplies timeout. We'll be back in a moment.
Every day is a party day at R&K Rentals. They furnish party supplies like jumping balloons and water slides. They offer cotton candy, popcorn, snow cone, and hot dog machines for rent. And they even have pinatas for sale. They also rent tables and chairs for any occasion. Call them today. That's R&K Rentals at 432-250-9611.
Hey Panther fans, this is Rudy Franco with Amistad Motors, inviting you to come out and take a look at our pre-owned inventory. We have a good selection of cars, trucks, and SUVs. We have several certified pre-owned units that come with an extended warranty. So if you are in the market for a new or pre-owned vehicle, drive on over to 2110 West Dickinson or give us a call at 336-9000. Amistad Motors, friends serving friends. Go Blue!
Okay, Darrell, this is possibly a very exciting finish here tonight.
Well, it's exciting.
Got a pretty big crowd here tonight at the Special Events Center on a Tuesday night. We got a 26-25 lead for Andrews, and we inbound the ball with 45 seconds left in the game. We missed a free throw a moment ago that could have tied it. And here's the inbounds play. Got to hurry. And here's Alondra Encinas getting that ball. Oh. Now we kick it out of bounds.
He called a foul. Did he?
No.
Okay.
No, he said
he's right. I mean, we did kick it out of bounds.
He said that Victoria kicked it out of bounds, and so 39 seconds now is all we have left, and we turn it over right there with a kick out of bounds. Didn't control the dribble. We were under a lot of pressure, no doubt. And here comes Andrews now with the ball and a one-point lead. They're trapped in the corner now, and they're going to call a timeout. And that's a pretty good timeout for Andrews.
Smart, yeah.
We'll be back in just a moment.
local real estate professional is Angie Miles at Turnkey Realty, offering experienced, professional, knowledgeable, and friendly real estate consultation. Angie Miles has over 30 years of sales experience and serves the entire Trans-Pecos area, including Fort Stockton, Pecos, Alpine, and Southwest Texas. She can show any listing and can list your residential, commercial, or farm and ranch property, and also offers property management services. For all your real estate needs, contact Angie Miles with Turnkey Realty, 804 North Main, or call 290-8038.
Well, Darrell, we just had a 30-second timeout there, but Andrews took it there as they were trapped in that corner between the half-court line and the sideline, trapped in that corner real well by the Prowlers. But it's a one-point game, and, you know, we could have tied it with a free throw. We missed that, and then we got the ball back again and kicked it out of bounds, unfortunately, and could not get a shot off.
Yeah, never got a shot off, and we, you know, we had them trapped. It was really a smart timeout by their coach because she was trapped. It amazes me that they dribble into that trap at this level, but I guess it's just a common thing.
All right, it's a one-point game. Andrews on top, and they've got possession. Kasten Tijerina, they inbound in the backcourt with Morrison.
They're going to go down to number 32.
And they may try to waste all the time on the clock. They've taken a lot of time with their possessions. Fort Stockton way out on the perimeter. Here's Morrison very smartly just dribbling time away on the clock. And there's a foul called. Fort Stockton's number five, Ivana Ortiz, call for her fourth foul. That'll put Morrison at the line with only
number five for her.
14 seconds.
She's out.
Oh, is she?
Yep.
All right. I had her with four. So an inbounds play now for Tijerina for Andrews. And that, let's see. I guess we're not in danger of putting him in the bonus unless it's a shooting foul. And here's Andrews. We cannot let them waste the time off this clock. You got a foul. You got a foul now. Got a foul. I mean, what? I don't get it, but, you know, there's a foul finally on Victoria Maldonado. You've got to foul. You can't let that much time run off the clock. And Andrews will be inbounding again. And, of course, there's no bonus. So Andrews is just going to win this game by dribbling the clock out. That's
It came down to our possession down here. We needed to get a shot off and didn't do it.
Okay, so Andrews wins this 26-25. They win it by dribbling the time off the clock. Well, Darrell, we'll be back in a moment, and we'll wrap up the game for you right after these words.
Glitzy Trends and the Glitzy Brew Coffee Shop is located at 1101 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton. Open Tuesday through Saturday. They offer delicious coffee, tea, smoothies, hot chocolate, fresh pastries, and desserts. Come down for bingo and loteria on Thursdays at 7 p.m. And Saturdays, Glitzy Trends has all-day games like darts, indoor cornhole, Jenga, checkers, chess, and board games. Come by Glitzy Trends and Glitzy Brew today, 1101 West Dickinson.
Do you know where you can get a great lunch special for a very affordable price? At Bienvenidos Mexican Food Restaurant, of course. Their lunch special is served Monday through Friday during lunchtime. Monday, it's the taco plate. Tuesday, it's the grilled chicken salad. Wednesday, it's Bienvenidos Nachos. Thursday, it's the hamburger basket. And Friday, it's the enchilada plate. You can come by Sunday through Friday from 9 to 11 a.m. for a delicious Mexican-style breakfast. Bienvenidos, open Sunday through Friday, starting at 9 a.m. at 405 East Dickinson.
Ram Country in Fort Stockton presents Warranty Forever, a warranty like no other, now covering every new Ram purchase from Fort Stockton's exclusive Ram dealer. No mileage limit, no year limit. Your new Ram is protected forever at no extra charge. Plus, Ram Country's Warranty Forever has no deductible and all parts and labor are covered. Log on to RamCountryFortStockton.com to shop online anytime. Then hurry to Ram Country and get your warranty forever at no extra charge.
When you need supplies in the oil field, the choice is clear. Choose Triple G Supply and Services in Fort Stockton. They have all the oil field supplies you need, including general oil field supplies, PVC pipe and fittings, hydraulic hoses, generators, safety equipment, household supplies, and much more. They also have roustabout services available. Triple G Supply and Services is right here in Fort Stockton at the west end of Dickinson at 1048 Crockett Avenue. Delivery is available to your location. Call 336-8284 Triple G Supply and Services. The Steakhouse Restaurant is back open again after a brief closure with new ownership and management, but still staying in the Pacheco family. The Steakhouse has been serving Fort Stockton and the surrounding area with consistently great food and fast, friendly service. They offer fantastic daily luncheon specials on weekdays at a great value. Each special comes with appropriate sides, soup or salad, and drink. Come by for a great meal. The Steakhouse Restaurant in Fort Stockton at 1100 West Dickinson.
Big Bend Concrete can provide quality, ready-mix concrete for any job you need to tackle. From a simple sidewalk or driveway to bigger projects that require multiple trucks for larger pours, or on-site batch plant setups at remote locations for commercial or private endeavors. You make the call, they'll make the pour. Proud to be the number one concrete provider in the Trans-Pecos Big Bend area, Big Bend Concrete, 837-7179. Solid.
All right, we're back to wrap up this ball game for you. The Andrews Lady Mustangs, they pull out a squeaker here tonight, 26-25 over the Prowlers. One big reason is that we were only 5 out of 13 from the free throw line.
Yeah, just one more free throw, and it's in overtime now, or they're probably shooting anyway.
Yeah, okay, so here's the wrap-up. We have we were outscored 9-4 in the first quarter. We scored evenly in the second, 7-7. We outscored Andrews 6-4 in the third quarter and outscored Andrews 8-6 in the fourth, and that made it a one-point game, Darrell, at the end. And Andrews just dribbled out the clock, like we said, at the end of the game, and we could not get the foul in time. And besides, they weren't close to being in the bonus, so that was a problem as well. When you're not close to the 5-team fouls required for free throws, you're probably not going to get the ball back.
Well, you don't want to be in the bonus or them to be in the bonus, but then you do at the end.
When you have that many fouls that you've got to make up, you've got to start fouling early.
You got to start early.
Right away on the ball handler so that you can get the ball back.
And in fairness to the Prowlers, the what was her name? Morrison, Kiki Morrison.
Yeah.
She's such a good ball handler. She scored early, but then we shut her down.
Yeah.
But she could handle the ball, and it was hard to catch her to even foul her.
Yeah. All right. So for Andrews, Charlize Rondon had 3 points, Tori Rodea 2, Kiki Morrison with 9, Cassine Tijerina with 6, Danley Fisher with 1, Allie Fulford with 5, and they shot only 4 out of 11 from the free throw line. So this was no offensive powerhouse showing tonight by either team. The Ottawa Slot had 5 points for the Prowlers. Amaya Urias, 2. Victoria Maldonado, 6. Alondra Encinas with 2. Kimbri Norman, 5. Kaylin Reeves with 5. And so we shoot 5 out of 13 from the free throw line, which, we could have tied the game at the end with a free throw, but we did not. We could not do it. So, Darrell, we're in the playoffs nevertheless because Greenwood has beaten Pecos tonight by 17, 45-28.
That was a two-point game at the half, so
yeah.
Interesting.
And Seminole defeated Monahans 103-12. We lose to Andrews 26-25. So here are the final district standings after the regular season is complete. Seminole is 10-0. Greenwood and Andrews are going to have to sort out second place. I don't know if they'll will play it off or, if they will flip a coin. I'm not sure.
If I was them, I'd want to play it in.
I would want to play it, especially if I were Greenwood, because Greenwood's better than this Andrews team. Greenwood and Andrews are both 7-3. Fort Stockton at 3-7. We clinched the fourth place spot, and our reward is having to play a top 10 or top 20, certainly a top 25 team, the Canyon Lady Eagles.
Well, we've done that before.
We have. And Pecos is 2-8, and Monahans is at 1-9, and that's the way the district standings finished up. So, Darrell, we do make the playoffs under new head coach Curtis Bishop with a 3-7 record. We split with Pecos, and we beat Monahans by twice in district play this year.
And, you know, I think all in all the team is improving.
Yeah. We lost to Andrews by 8 on the road. Right. We lost to them by 1 here at home.
And, you know, I'm just, you know, thinking back last year, we pretty much struggled in every game with the exception of Monahans and Pecos. So, it was close.
All right, and we'll be back. We've got Panther basketball coming up. It's senior night here for the Panthers as well, I think. And so we'll be back in just a moment.
It's time now for Fort Stockton High School Prowler Basketball on KFST AM and FM, KFSTRadio.com, and KFST's Facebook and YouTube pages. Prowler Basketball is being brought to you by Amistad Motors, Angie Miles at Turnkey Realty, Glitzy Trends and Glitzy Brew, BM Donitos Mexican Food, Ram Country, Triple G Supply and Services, Rainwater Motor Company, The Steakhouse Restaurant, Big Ben Concrete, Bucks Loop Center, Cactus Health Services, Citibank, Concept Inc., Contessa Ready Mix, CTG Express, Designer Carpets and Interiors, The First National Bank, Fort Stockton ISD, Fort Stockton Insurance Agency, The Guadalajara Mexican Grill, Hernandez Sanitation, Heritage Funeral Home, by Julie's Easy Press, K-Bob Steakhouse, M&J Trucking, M&J Fast Loop, Sawyer Insurance, Porky's Ice House, Stockton Glass and Mirror, Triple R Welding, Weiss Tire, Salcedo Urgent Care and Family Medicine, by Sagebrush Cafe, Permian Basin Abstract, West Texas Eye Care, Pecos County State Bank, Little Regina Trucking, R&K Rentals and Party Supplies, and Besitos de Azúcar. Now stay tuned for Prowler Basketball.
The Guadalajara Mexican Grill in Fort Stockton features authentic Jalisco-style Mexican food with friendly and fast service. They're open starting at 8 a.m. for breakfast daily until 9:30 each night, Tuesday through Thursday, and until 10 p.m. Friday through Sunday. They also feature delicious Mexican desserts, along with beer, piña coladas, margaritas, and micheladas, with great specials every day. The Guadalajara Mexican Grill at 200 East 19th in Fort Stockton on the Imperial Highway.
It's time now for Fort Stockton High School Panther Basketball on KFST AM and FM, KFSTRadio.com, and KFST's Facebook and YouTube pages. Panther Basketball brought to you by Amistad Motors, Angie Miles at Turnkey Realty, Glitzy Trends and Glitzy Brew, Bienvenidos Mexican Food Restaurant, Ram Country, Triple G Supply and Services, Rainwater Motor Company, The Steakhouse Restaurant, Big Ben Concrete, Bucks Loop Center, Cactus Health Services, Citibank, Concept Inc., Contessa Ready Mix, CTG Express, Designer Carpets and Interiors, The First National Bank, Fort Stockton ISD, Fort Stockton Insurance, The Guadalajara Mexican Grill, Adnanda Sanitation, by Heritage Funeral Home, Julie's Easy Press, K-Bob Steakhouse, M&J Trucking, M&J Fast Loop, Sawyer Insurance, Porky's Ice House, Stockton Glass and Mirror, Triple R Welding, Weiss Tire, Salcedo Urgent Care and Family Medicine, Sagebrush Cafe, Permian Basin Abstract, West Texas Eye Care, Pecos County State Bank, Little Regina Trucking, R&K Rentals and Party Supplies, and by Besitos de Azúcar. Now stay tuned for Panther Basketball.
Hernandez Sanitation in Fort Stockton proudly serves a large portion of West Texas with sanitation services, including the oil field, for portable toilets, holding tanks, septic tank service, grease trap service, or large roll-off trash containers. Contact Hernandez Sanitation today by calling owner and operator Joe Angel Hernandez at 432-336-3803. Hernandez Sanitation, a proud member of the Fort Stockton community, always supporting all the athletic and extracurricular activities in Fort Stockton schools.
Heritage Funeral Home in Fort Stockton is here to serve you and your family in times of need. Remember, not only is everybody somebody in Fort Stockton, Texas, but everybody is treated like family at Heritage Funeral Home. When they receive your loved one into their care, you can be sure that they will honor your family's heritage. Call Heritage Funeral Home at 432-336-3939 or go by 301 North Main Street and allow them to help you pre-plan your or your family's final farewell.
Julie's Easy Press Cleaners is ready to serve you with all your laundry cleaning needs, from drop-off to pick-up. You'll enjoy not having to do the washing, drying, or pressing. It's done for you. Whether it's a party, office meeting, or lunch with friends, show up dressed for success. Because at Julie's Easy Press, they know when you look good, you feel good. Julie's Easy Press, 1101 North Front Street, or call 336-6601.
At K-Bob Steakhouse in Fort Stockton, we pride ourselves on great food, great service, and great atmosphere. We work hard every day to make sure that every trip to Kaybob's is worth your time. Whether it's lunch with friends, a family dinner, or a special occasion, Kaybob's is always here to serve you the food America loves. Kaybob's Steakhouse, Fort Stockton, 2800 West Dickinson.
All right, we're back. We're getting ready for their boys game now between the Andrews Mustangs and the Fort Stockton Panthers. And Daryl, I'll tell you, the Mustangs are 3-4 in district. We're 1-6, and I think we've been improving. I think we have a chance to beat these guys tonight.
Well, I certainly hope so. That's
yeah. All right, so their
what
coach.
What you want is to improve as the season goes.
Absolutely. David Smiley is their coach. They're 11-17 overall, and they're 3-4 in district play.
Is he pretty happy about their season?
Jesse Gonzalez just walked up. And hello, Jesse.
Hello, guys.
Yeah. Well, I'm not even going to say what you're a candidate for. Let them figure it out themselves. Right? We're going to zip it. Okay. Let's take a look at the Andrews roster. And, Daryl, I'll let you take a look at the Fort Stockton roster. Kevin Villegas is a 5'10 junior point guard for Andrews, number 0. Jet Fisher, number 3, a 6-foot senior point guard. Xavier Ramos, number 4, a junior. Cade Adams is number 11, a junior. Sebastian Gonzalez, number 14, a junior. Aiden Olivas, number 20, a senior. Jace McGruff, number 21, a junior.
Let's take a bite out of crime.
Absolutely. And Grant Fitzgerald, number 23, a junior guard. Garrett Marshall, number 24, a senior. And then it was John Nevis, number 30, a junior center. A.J. Mayfield, number 32, a junior. And Bryson Diaz, number 45, a senior center. So those are the Andrews Mustangs. All right, Daryl.
And for Fort Stockton, we have a 6'4 senior, Julian Leyva. A senior, Luis Medina. We also have a sophomore, Diego Ronquillo. We have a senior, Aaron Hernandez. And Marco Garcia, a senior, 6 foot. Alex Granado, who is a senior. All of them being honored tonight as the seniors. Kael Rojillo, a junior. Sophomore, Cash Norman. A junior, Christian Soto. A junior, Yandre Reyes. And Adric Gallegos, he is a junior guard, Evan Cordero, and a junior forward, Andre Washington.
All right, Daryl, and some of these guys have, you know, come quite a long way. Julian Leyva, now these are our normal starters. Julian Leyva, Diego Ronquillo, Cash Norman, Jandre Reyes, and Andre Washington. You know, since it's, I'm really not sure if it's senior night because we have one more game to go at home, and I think it's this Friday night against Greenwood, if I'm not mistaken.
Well,
and then we
be.
Finish on the road at Pecos. The boys have two more games to go in the regular season, so
they did something with the seniors. I thought it was very appropriate. They gave them a basketball and put it in a basket.
Well, okay, yeah, that's
they,
good.
You know,
yeah, and they made them.
Well, they had. Sadly, there was a bottom in the basket, and so none of them went through. But
okay.
But you couldn't take it out, or it'd be goaltending. So,
someone was telling me, I think it was Ruben Falcone, during the Melvin Reynolds days, he had a cap that he would a top that he would put on the basket.
Yeah.
You know, and they would just practice shooting, but.
Rebounding.
I mean, the exercise was rebounding because the ball is not going to go in a basket with a top on it. So they just practiced rebounding. That's pretty good exercise,
Melvin
I would say.
Reynolds knew what he was doing, and we were basketball forced to be reckoned with.
Yep. Okay, we'll be back. We've got Panther basketball coming up next against Andrews. Should be an exciting one here at the Special Events Center. And Fort Stockton at 1-6 in district, Andrews at 3-4. We'll be back in a moment.
M&J Trucking Services supports our Fort Stockton Panther and Prowler athletic teams and wants you to know that there's a locally owned and operated oilfield trucking company that can handle your vacuum truck and water hauling in the surrounding area. It's M&J Trucking in Fort Stockton, offering 24-hour-a-day, 7-day-a-week vacuum truck and water hauling service. Contact M&J Trucking today at 290-4510. M&J Trucking, owned and operated by Martin Ibarra, proudly supporting the Fort Stockton Panthers and Prowlers.
Sawyer Insurance Agency has six locations in West Texas to serve you, including 706 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton and 1502 South Stockton Avenue in Monahans, along with offices in Pecos, Midland, Lubbock, and Amarillo. They offer the most complete line of commercial and personal insurance from workers' comp, general liability, business and personal auto, commercial property, equipment, oil and gas, farm and ranch, and home insurance. Contact Clyde, Nathan, or Travis Sawyer today by calling 336-7543 or 943-9600. Porky's Ice House in Fort Stockton is the place to get your drinks and snacks in Fort Stockton, with two convenient drive-through lanes open 7 days a week for teas, lemonades, and fountain drinks with added flavors upon request and much more. Go by Porky's Ice House, and remember, happy hour is each day from 4 to 6 p.m. with all drinks any size for just a dollar. They also make popular Clamato, Squirt, Topo Chico, and Jerky Preparados that are delicious, along with nachos. Porky's Ice House, 1401 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton.
Need a quick, efficient oil change? M&J Fast Lube at 116 West Dickinson is here to serve you. Martine and Julia Ibarra invite you to stop by. They have great service, and they offer auto oil and lube services with the top major oil brands. They also offer state inspections and vehicle washing and cleaning, or you can get your vehicle completely detailed. It'll look like you just bought it. That's M&J Fast Lube, 116 West Dickinson, supporting Panther and Prowler Sports. Go Blue!
Stockton Glass and Mirror is locally owned and operated and welcomes you to give them a call for a free estimate on any job. They're your premier commercial and residential glass installation company, proudly serving the Trans-Pecos and Big Bend for more than 30 years. Stockton Glass and Mirror offers quality glass products professionally installed, along with broken glass repair, shower enclosures, and much more. Open Monday through Friday, 8 to noon and 1 to 5. Call 336-3152 or go by 202 East 5th Street. Stockton Glass and Mirror, glass west of the Pecos.
Triple R Welding, located at 2215 West 9th, is here for all your residential, commercial, or oil field needs. From roustabout, hotshot, and certified welding to building and installing your own personalized one-of-a-kind fence and entrance. Bring them your ideas and they can make it happen. Call 336-5289. Triple R Welding. They can weld anything except a broken heart and the crack of dawn. Visit them today at 2215 West 9th Street or call 336-5289.
Wiese Tire is the clear choice in Fort Stockton and West Texas for all your tire needs, with reasonable prices and the best customer service. They've been here for over 35 years and are locally owned and operated. They offer a huge selection of new tires available from many brands, along with rotations, alignment, oil changes, brake jobs, air conditioning, recharging, and other minor auto repair and maintenance. Plus, all major credit cards are accepted and financing is available. Go by and see Wiese Tire, 701 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton.
Mesitos de Azucar is a great local bakery at 302 East Dickinson, now open every day, including Monday through Friday, 6:30 a.m. till 6 p.m., Saturday, 7:30 a.m. to 8 p.m., and Sundays, 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. They offer pastries and cookies, sweetbreads, lunch and breakfast served all day, and sandwiches are served on their delicious fresh bread. You can also buy bread loaves by the dozen. Visit the Facebook page of Mesitos de Azucar for new items. They have menudo, tortas, caldos, and all kinds of breakfast and lunch sandwiches. Mesitos de Azucar at 302 East Dickinson.
All right, we're back. Here's Andrews with first possession. They put up the three ball from the right wing. It's no good. Here's Medina. We've got four seniors starting tonight. Oh. And there is Marco Garcia putting up a shot right under the basket. Misses.
Good penetration, just a little too far under.
And here come the Mustangs to the right corner. They put up a three ball. It is good for number 24, Garrett Marshall. Peter Marshall was the game show host of the Hollywood Squares.
Yes,
so that's
yes. Was on the outside square for an innings.
All right, here's Diego, and now here's Fort Stockton going inside. Stripped of the ball is Arian Hernandez. I believe Fort Stockton just last touched it on the baseline of Andrews. Yeah. So they will get it back.
Good defensive block, because he looked like he was going to make an easy layup.
Andrews is leading the game here, 3-0.
Oh, me.
Andrews put up another shot. That's a nice rebound by Julian Leyva.
Yeah, good, tough rebound.
Luis Medina on the right wing now, almost stripped of the ball. Back to Leyva. And now here's Ronquillo, who's a good shooter, but he has been, you know, ever since the district found out he's so good from the three-point line, they guard him pretty closely out on the perimeter.
What a
Shot by Julian Leyva. And he's fouled. It's going to be a 2-and-1 opportunity for Julian.
Yeah, that's. I think he's going to have a step on 45. 45 is a big boy. How much does it, they have his weight, or they just?
No, I don't think so.
We just have his name, huh?
All right, Julian Leyva. He's a 6'4 senior center for the Panthers, and the shot is no good. We got a lane violation on somebody, so it's going to be on the Panthers, and so they're going to allow the inbounds play now for Andrews. Number 45, Bryson Diaz, was called for that foul for Andrews. All right, here comes Andrews. They've got Villegas, number 0, out there at the top of the key. And they tried to get it to their big man inside, deflected. Diego Ronquillo picks it up. Here he is. And he thought about a three, did not take it. Now Leyva tries to work it inside. That was a nice play by Julian. Julian got the assist, and Luis Medina got the basket.
Yeah, Julian, he's going to be able to work around number 45, and they're either going to foul him or we're going to score.
And Andrews now trying to get it inside, and they work it to their big man inside. That's no good. Leyva, he's kind of pushed out, but he loses the ball in the process. It'll be Andrews' ball.
Couldn't find the handle on it.
Andrews, Jace McGruff will inbound. I think the PA announcer called him McGraw, but I'm calling him McGruff.
Oh, he's McGruff.
The ball is on the floor, and Andrews, shot by Bryson Diaz. He scores. Andrews takes the lead, 5-4. Bad pass. Xavier Ramos for Andrews picks it off. Here come the Mustangs over on the right wing. Goes to McGruff. Here's the shot taken. No good by Andrews. Rebound by Julian Leyva. Boy, I tell you, Julian does a nice job of controlling the boards. Travel on Fort Stockton on Medina, I believe.
Well, the turnover bug, we got to get rid of it.
Yeah. Andrews is up by 1, 5-4. 5:08 to go, first period. All right, here come the Mustangs with no backcourt pressure. And here's the lob pass near the free throw line. Another three taken. Good again by Garrett Marshall. We are going to have to guard that guy.
Have to guard him. And really, he was out there by himself.
Well, they're already at halftime in Seminole tonight in the boys' game.
Foul,
and here's a foul
24
on Andrews, Garrett Marshall. So, yeah, they're already at halftime. In Seminole tonight, and Monahans is leading the Seminole Indians 30-25. Diego Ronquillo misses a three. It takes a ricochet and will not go down. And that's a triple R welding three-point attempt by the Panthers. No good. And Andrews has made two of theirs. Fast break.
Here's
down to Luis Medina.
He's going to call him for traveling. That's just not right.
Well,
was that a travel?
I don't think so. I think that, you know.
Jesse says no.
I don't think so either.
Jesse's like those guys in the broadcast where you check on them, see if they got that.
I know, yeah. We're going to look at Jesse and say, Jesse, what do you think about that call? But that was Darren's favorite official making that call as well. It's 8-4. Andrews on top. Andrews tries to go inside. Deflected there by Arian Hernandez. We pick it off. And that is a layup attempt, no good, from the outside by Medina. He was a little too far out, and it was fairly well defended. That's a steal by Ronquillo, and he anticipated that pass. And here's Diego laying it in for the Panthers.
He had to dodge a referee.
And that closes the game to a two-point lead for Andrews, 8-6. Andrews on top. Here's McGruff over on the left wing.
That's a travel.
Andrews over on the right wing. They go to their good three-point shooter, who's now being guarded by Garcia. Here's a three-pointer on the way. That's no good. Rebound by Medina for the Panthers. Medina down to Garcia. And that is a tipped
nice
ball to Julian, open for the shot, and he makes it. Julian Leyva. Beautiful long-range jumper from inside the arc. And that's it ties the game 8-8 right there. Beautiful shot by Julian.
And a nice little assist there from whoever that was.
All right, here's Andrews. They go inside, almost have it picked off, but here's McGruff inside now, cut off. They try a three ball. It is good again from the top of the key by Jet Fisher. They have 9 points from the three-point line.
Yeah, they're a good three-point shooting team.
Diego Ronquillo, cross-court pass over to Arian Hernandez. And here's a Medina again trying a shot from too far out. A lay-in won't go. Second time he's tried that. Here comes Andrews, a three-pointer on the way again. Good again by Garrett Marshall. He's got three threes.
We're going to have to get out and guard him, or it's going to be a rough game.
14-8, Panthers trail now after two big threes by Andrews just recently. Now here's Medina. They have four three-pointers. Here's Diego with a three.
Oh! That ought to be worth four.
Diego Ronquillo with a triple R welding three-pointer for the Panthers. And we answer, and we're still down by three, though, 14-11 with a minute 45 in the first quarter. A three put up by Andrews, no good. And a rebound by Medina for the Panthers. Here come the Panthers now with Luis Medina across the midcourt line. A minute 33 to go, first quarter. Julian Leyva near the free throw line. Soft jumper, in and out, no good.
I like
Julian,
the shot.
Julian's got a nice looking shot.
Yeah.
Jet Fisher across the midcourt line. Now they try to go inside. Blocked by Julian, but they're going to call a foul on Leyva. But a good defensive play, but he did get a little bit of the wrist there.
He got a little bit of him.
Garrett Marshall at the line, who has three threes tonight. He is a senior for Andrews. A minute 12 to go, first quarter. And here's Andrews with the shot. In and out, no good.
He ought to back up, shoot from the three-point line.
He can shoot the three, but he can't shoot the free throw. In and out. All right, Garrett Marshall at the line again. We make some subs, I believe. Christian Soto comes in and Andre Washington come in. Cash Norman also in the game. Here's the shot. It's good.
He's got a soft touch.
Andrews on top.
Pull him out.
15-11. Yeah, he goes out. And Christian Soto will be inbounding for our Panthers to Cash Norman. And now Cash Norman has got a different jersey every game. I'm trying to figure out what number he's going
to
be.
Trying to keep him confused. Nice pass, Cash.
And there's Christian Soto putting up a layup attempt. And we got a foul on Andrews here. It's on Aiden Olivas, I believe, number 20. With 57 seconds to go, first quarter. Andrews is on top, 15-11. And Christian Soto will go to the free throw line. 6'4 junior guard, Christian Soto. And the shot is good.
Nice. Nice stroke.
Brought to you by Rainwater Motor Company. Christian Soto goes to the line again. Another Rainwater Motor Company free throw attempt. And here's the shot. It's short, no good. A lane violation. Called by Mr. Edens again.
Well.
Right, here's the inbounds play for Andrews. McGruff brings it across the free throw line. Here's McGruff with the ball. Passes out to, there's a tipped ball. And Cade Adams picks it up. Back over to Villegas. Andrews with black uniforms with gray numerals trimmed in gold. That's kind of unusual.
Yeah, kind of hard to read.
Foul called on Diego Ronquillo. 31 seconds. Andrew is with a three-point lead, 15-12. That's your Little Regina Trucking game score. Inbounds play right under the basket, but a block by Andre Washington. Good job by Andre. Here's Christian Soto. Now off to Diego Ronquillo. Really nice pass by Diego. He's got a strong arm. And now Andre. Here's Cash. He can't handle that pass in the corner from Andre. Turn it over, and it's 14 seconds to go in the first period. Andrew's on top, 15-12. Do not let him have a three. That's all I can say before halftime. Yeah, I mean, before the end of this quarter.
It'd be better to keep him out of the backcourt for a while.
I think we figured out that they've had four threes in this first quarter. 12 of their 15 points. There's a foul.
I don't like that.
On Fort Stockton.
I thought he traveled with the ball long before he got fouled.
I think it's, let's see. They're going to call it on Cash Norman, I guess. But, again, he's got the different jersey on tonight. Let me change his number here on my book.
It makes him hard to scout.
Number zero there, Kevin Villegas, makes the first free throw for Andrews. Now they've got a four-point lead, 16-12. Here's Villegas. Free throw line again for Andrews. And it's no good.
The
ball
gracious.
Is out of bounds. Tipped out by Andrews, though, so we'll get the ball.
No, it's out on us.
Oh, well, the first official said it was our ball. All right, here's the inbounds play, and that's a good block by Christian Soto of a three-point shot at the buzzer. It remains 16-12. Andrew's leading. We'll be back in a moment.
If you're needing personal attention to your medical needs, visit Salceda Urgent Care and Family Medicine in Fort Stockton at 703 North Main. They can help with life's little urgencies that cannot wait for an appointment. They provide urgent care, hormone optimization for men and women, vitamin supplements, family medicine, chronic care for all ages, including cholesterol treatment, blood pressure, diabetes, thyroid optimization, and treat many other conditions. Call for appointments 360-3029. Walk-ins are welcome at 703 North Main.
Looking for home cooking away from home? Sagebrush Cafe at 2003 West Dickinson is your answer. Mondays, try their chicken fried steak special for only $6.99. Tuesdays, it's the specialty burger and fries and wings special Wednesday. They serve the best breakfast around and they serve it all day long. Sagebrush Cafe offers many other menu items like catfish, salads, and Mexican food also. Sagebrush Cafe, 2003 West Dickinson for home-cooked food away from home.
Permian Basin Abstract Company has the experts ready to help everyone with their real estate closings at 600 West Dickinson. With locations in Andrews, Seminole, Pecos, and Fort Stockton, they have complete real estate records, including every record filed in Pecos, Reeves, Loving, Gaines, and Andrews counties, along with mineral records. They welcome landmen and surveyors for research. Great customer service is their number one goal at Permian Basin Abstract. Open Monday through Friday and during the lunch hour from 8 a.m. till 5 p.m. At the corner of Dickinson and the Monahans Highway in Fort Stockton, call 336-3301.
All right, Panthers inbounded the ball, but the ball ricocheted around a little bit there, and Andrews came away with it. Here come the Mustangs trying to go into the lane. Now they push it back out to their good three-point shooter. He misses that one, and the ball will go back to Fort Stockton here. 7:38 remaining second quarter now.
Maybe they'll go cold on the three-pointers, and we can make some progress here. Four-point game. It's close.
16-12. It's your Panthers down by four with 7.5 to go in the second quarter. Andre Washington penetrates inside, tries to put up a reverse layup. No good. Christian Soto right there for a putback after an offensive rebound. Panthers are now down just by two. And your Little Regina Trucking game score now 16-14. And the Mustangs on top. They go into the lane. That's a nice defensive play by Andre Washington.
And then we threw it away.
Yeah, but Washington did a great job on their post that time. All right, 7:06 to go. And, you know, Washington, I think, in his last game against Monahans had 13 points to lead the Panthers. He's getting better and better with every game.
He's very athletic, and he's a big guy.
Yeah, he's a big guy and athletic, yeah. Moves well, and he can handle the ball too. Here's Andrews out to the top with Kevin Villegas. We're down by two, 16-14, 6:58 second quarter. And now their big man goes inside, back out because of good defense on Andre by Andre. Got a foul on Christian Soto here. All right, we've got 6:48 to go, second period. We're supposed to be keeping fouls by quarter, and our scoreboard is stuck at five on each team, and I don't think that's right. This is a shooting foul. I don't think they reset the fouls in the quarter.
In the middle one, they're showing us with one foul in this quarter.
Are those timeouts? Okay.
Yeah, those.
Well, okay, yeah, the fouls are up above. Okay, that's right. And that free throw is good. Thank you, Mr. Official.
Very officially.
Uh-oh. Put the score on the wrong side of the board. Oh, that's a three by Diego Ronquillo for the Panthers.
That'll make you well in a hurry.
And that ties up the game 17-17. Stripped of the ball by Cash Norman. Here comes Andre Washington in the lane. And Andre scores the basket. It is a blocking foul called on Andrews. Number three, Jet Fisher. I like that call.
Yeah, and Andre demonstrated what we was talking about. Very athletic. He moves good for a big man.
Fort Stockton really is on top now, 19-17. That's your Little Regina Trucking game score. And Andre trying to put us up by three with a Rainwater Motor Company free throw after that foul. What a nice play by Andre.
Yeah, that was very nice.
All right, here he is at the free throw line. It is good. Panthers are up now by 3 points, 20-17. The Mustangs in the backcourt. A little bit of pressure, but the Panthers retreat. And here they come with a layup. Yeah. It's a point-blank shot good and a foul on Diego Ronquillo. And Diego has the disadvantage of guarding a much taller guy right now.
He's got a tough task in front of him.
If I'm not mistaken, it was Grant Fitzgerald, maybe? Is that number 23 at the
23,
line? Yes, it is.
Yeah.
So he makes the basket and the free throw. Ties it up 20-20. Cash Norman now bringing it down. Norman bounce pass back out to Soto. And here's a pass out to the left wing. We try to go in for the basket by Kyle Rojero.
I like the drive. Make good things happen.
Got a foul called.
Who was the foul on 23?
Okay, that would be Grant Fitzgerald.
Right. Really, nobody in any foul trouble here. We need to make free throws. Make them count.
And here's the shot. It's good. Rainwater Motor Company free throw. And here's Kyle Rojero at the free throw line again with a Rainwater Motor Company free throw, a 5'10 junior guard. Panthers are up by one now. Here's the second free throw. That's good.
Good. Good.
Panthers are up 22-20 over the Mustangs. That's your Little Regina Trucking game score. Here come the Mustangs in the backcourt. They're being hounded by the Panthers. It's a reach-in foul there on Kyle Rojero for the Panthers. We've got, I think, Diego Ronquillo is the only guy with two fouls for us.
That's correct.
And Cade Adams will inbound the ball. Here's Adams. And they work it into the lane. There's an easy basket and a nice offensive play to Bryson Diaz on that inbounds play.
That's hard for one person to guard two.
Yep. Here's Andre Washington out front. Evan Cordero in the game now. He tries a three. Oh, it's no good off the back iron. Nice rebound by Rojero. Andre shoots the ball, and that's no good off the back iron.
Got a foul underneath.
Number 11, Cade Adams, I believe, called for the foul.
And Three fouls for each team. So.
Yeah, that's right. Kyle Rojero inbounding to Washington. And now he decides to keep the ball. He said, here it is, and then he changed his mind.
He ought to drive on the Diaz because Washington's just so much more athletic.
Ronquillo screened for a three. Takes a long one. And we're going to have a foul, I guess, over the back on Cordero. I think that's what Mr. Edens is calling.
I like the threes. I don't like them 4 and 5 feet outside the three-point line.
We're all tied up. That's your Little Regina game score, 22-22. With second quarter, 5:16 to go. And that ball punched out from behind by Arian Hernandez, but we couldn't control the ball after we got it punched out. Andrews will get it back. 22-22 with 5:10 to go, second period. Inbounds play for the Mustangs on their own baseline. Long pass in, and here comes Andrews with a floater in the lane. No good by Kevin Villegas. Here come the Panthers now with Arian Hernandez. Diego thought about a three, did not take it. Evan takes a three. It won't go. Evan has taken a couple of them, and they just won't fall for him. Kevin Villegas now. But the good news is, Darryl, that Andrews has not had any threes in the second quarter. There's a fast break now for the Panthers, and we miss a layup, but a foul called on Andrews. Yeah. Number 23, Grant Fitzgerald, call for his second foul.
Well, and like the girls' game, we had a slow start, but playing well. Playing well now.
All right, Kyle Rojero will be going to the free throw line for the Panthers, a 5'10 junior guard. In a tie ball game, Rainwater Motor Company free throw off the back iron is no good. Rojero had made two, and now he's got two out of three. So here he is with another Rainwater Motor Company free throw. It's a 5'10 junior guard. 4:39 left, second quarter. Score all knotted up. And that free throw gets the roll, and it's good.
1-point lead for the Panthers, 23-22. They brought in their three-point. No, they didn't bring in the three. Yeah, the three-point shooters back in the game.
I want to thank the Pecos County State Bank for making our video streams possible. And here's Andrews. They weren't quite ready for that pass, but now they try to get it inside. Good defense again by Washington on their big man. Here's a three put up. I tell you, Andrews can shoot that three ball. If you leave them alone on the perimeter, they're dangerous.
Well, they penetrate and they draw people in, and somebody's always hanging around that three-point line.
25-23, Andrews on top. That is they've got 15 of their 25 points from the free throw line. Diego Ronquillo stripped to the ball. And, wow, that was Arian Hernandez almost getting down for that ball. But that's a block by Evan Cordero. And here comes Washington. And under the basket, Medina misses a point-blank shot. And here's a fadeaway jumper by Andre Washington. It is good. Panthers tie it up 25-25. Nice shot by Washington. And here come the Mustangs now with Jet Fisher over on the right wing, right corner, bounce pass inside.
Good
defensive Washington. Play by Washington. Here come the Panthers, a 4-on-1. And our ball handler decided to go on in for the shot. And that's Medina. He's fouled by Andrews. Number 21, I believe, Jace McGruff. Call for the foul, and it'll be Luis Medina going to the free throw line for the Panthers. And Luis Medina will go for Rainwater Motor Company free throws.
Timeout.
Timeout on the court. We'll take this R&K Reynolds and Party Supplies timeout and be back in a moment.
Doctors Josh Pass, Brian Cherry, and Hewlin Pass are optometrists serving the West Texas area. Visit West Texas Eye Care at 605 North Main in Fort Stockton or 611 South Oak in Pecos. They offer complete and thorough eye examinations for the whole family, including therapeutic optometry, eyeglasses, contact lenses, laser surgery consultation, and screenings for macular degeneration and diabetes with an in-office lab. Call to make an appointment today in Fort Stockton at 336-3662 or in Pecos 445-3662.
All right, we're back with a tie score, 25-25. Andrews and Fort Stockton here at the Special Event Center. Really an entertaining game here, Darrell.
Very entertaining, and, you know, really the Panthers are playing pretty well. When you look at the number of threes that Andrews has drained, we've hit a few, but inside we're able to make some hay.
Well, Monahans is leading Seminole boys 30-25 at halftime. Luis Medina at the free throw line. And the first shot by Luis is good. Brought to you by Rainwater Motor Company. Here's another one by Luis. Panthers take the lead on that shot. And here's Medina with another free throw. Shot is good.
Oh, excellent.
That makes it a 27-25 lead for the Panthers. And here comes Andrews down the right wing. And inside, Andrews going to be called for a foul. Are they going to call that shot good? Yes, they
are.
They're
going to call it good.
And they're going to call Jondre Reyes perhaps for the foul, number 24. Is he even in the game? No. Who did they call?
Well, he's fixing to come into the game. Must have been on number four. Well, I guess number five. It was on number five.
Okay. Arian Hernandez with his first. All right. That free throw is good by number three there, Jet Fisher. So he made the basket and the free throw. That gives Andrews a one-point lead, 28-27. Now here's Diego Ronquillo. Here's a blocked three-point shot by Garrett Marshall. Underneath the basket, point-blank shot is missed by Medina. We tie it up. Oh, that's getting pretty physical. Here comes Medina. Misses a shot underneath.
Oh.
Foul called on Andrews.
Yeah, it's getting a little bit wild under the basket.
Number 32 for Andrews, A.J. Mayfield, call for the foul. And here's Medina at the free throw line again for the Panthers. Two Rainwater Motor Company free throws coming. He made his last two. And the free throws, good on the first one.
Shooters roll.
That ties the game, 28-28. Medina can give us the lead right here with 2.5 minutes to go, second quarter. Rainwater Motor Company free throw. And it is good.
I'm impressed with our free throw shooting tonight. Very
right,
good.
29-28, Panthers on top. And now here come the Mustangs in the backcourt. Some pressure by the Panthers. Here's McGruff across the midcourt line. Panther defense is playing very well tonight. That ball goes out of bounds off of McGruff. I'm impressed with the Panther defense tonight.
Yeah, playing good.
The only thing we've allowed is a few three-pointers, but it's hard to stop that.
It's hard to stop it, and it's hard to live by it because if you go cold.
Diego Ronquillo out at the top of the key. Back to Evan Cordero. 2 minutes now to go in the first half. Evan tries to penetrate inside, puts up the floater. It's no good. And Andrews has the rebound. Fast break. And they've got the layup against Diego Ronquillo, and Jet Fisher gets that shot. And Ronquillo is just really outsized with that matchup. And now Jet Fisher.
Oh, nice pass.
All right, there's Diego Ronquillo with the putback. Is good.
He robbed Washington of an assist by missing the first time.
All right, here's McGruff in the backcourt. Oh, that's a bumping foul on Luis Medina. No need for that. Let's see.
We're shooting now, so that's bad.
It is 31-30, Fort Stockton leading, and they're going to go to the free throw line because I believe both teams are now in the bonus here in the second quarter. What's the number on that free throw shooter? Is it?
Number 11, I think.
Okay. And that free throw is good by Cade Adams. And that brings us back to a tie. We've had a lot of lead changes and ties in this game. Cade Adams at the free throw line. And this is no good off the back iron. And Andrews has the offensive rebound. They try to come into the paint with it. Go back out front. There's a lay-in by Andrews. They penetrated in the lane, found an opening. That was a nice shot by Andrews right there.
Oh.
Who made that one?
Cash Norman with a three.
He had a three?
He had a three.
All right. Panthers with a triple R welding three-point shot right there. Nice job by, and there's a layup by Jet Fisher, penetrated into the lane. And, man, Jet Fisher is on fire here in the second quarter for Andrews. And that's a miss by the Panthers. Now here comes Andrews with Jet Fisher again. And it's a foul in the backcourt.
Again.
On number 24, Jondre Reyes.
You hate that because it's shooting.
It's Andrews 35, Fort Stockton 34. That is our score.
19 seconds left to go in the half.
And they've got a chance at the free throw line, and Jet Fisher misses that one. He's got another one. He's got 14 points in the first half.
Goodness.
All right, here's Jet Fisher at the line. It is up. It's no good off the back iron. Looked like a bump in the back, but here comes Evan Cordero. Now to Jondre Reyes. He misses a layup. Andre Washington puts it back up, and he looked like he was fouled and nothing called. What do we have to do, Darryl, to get a call?
Well,
that is a nice save by Evan Cordero off of Andrews. And that's just a beautiful play. And the Mustangs have a one-point lead. 3 seconds is all we have left in the first half.
Yeah, I thought Andre got mugged under the basket.
He did. Got to hurry. 2 seconds.
Get in.
And that is going to be a three-point shot from more than half court at the buzzer. Andrews has a one-point lead at halftime over the Panthers. All right, we'll be back at halftime with some stats right after these words.
This is Dakota Livesay for the Pecos County State Bank. Experience is a great teacher. The Pecos County State Bank has been in business since 1928. Over all those years, we've gained a lot of experience. At the Pecos County State Bank, you will find answers to your questions and people who understand what you need. You will find experience. A Texas institution since 1928, the Pecos County State Bank. All the bank you'll ever need. Member FDIC.
Do you need dirt work done, trash hauling, roll-off dumpsters, a location built, line locating? Well, then look no further than Little Regina Trucking. They do it all and offer very reasonable prices, too. Stop by at 701 North Rooney or call 432-250-9611 7 days a week, 24 hours a day. Little Regina Trucking. We'll get it done. Amistad Motors in Fort Stockton specializes in the sales and service of new and pre-owned vehicles. They deal in sport utility vehicles, cars, convertibles, sedans, wagons, and minivans. The dealership service department caters to the basic service needs of vehicles and stocks genuine parts and accessories. They also have a finance department that offers assistance with payment calculations and a variety of financing and leasing options. Amistad Motors, located at 2110 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton. Every day is a party day at RNK Rentals. They furnish party supplies like jumping balloons and water slides. They offer cotton candy, popcorn, snow cone, and hot dog machines for rent, and they even have piñatas for sale. They also rent tables and chairs for any occasion. Call them today. That's RNK Rentals at 432-250-9611.
Your local real estate professional is Angie Miles at Turnkey Realty, offering experienced, professional, knowledgeable, and friendly real estate consultation. Angie Miles has over 30 years of sales experience and serves the entire Trans-Pecos area, including Fort Stockton, Pecos, Alpine, and Southwest Texas. She can show any listing and can list your residential, commercial, or farm and ranch property, and also offers property management services. For all your real estate needs, contact Angie Miles with Turnkey Realty, 804 North Main, or call 290-80. Glitzy Trends and the Glitzy Brew Coffee Shop is located at 1101 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton. Open Tuesday through Saturday. They offer delicious coffee, tea, smoothies, hot chocolate, fresh pastries, and desserts. Come down for bingo and loteria on Thursdays at 7 p.m. And Saturdays, Glitzy Trends has all-day games like darts, indoor cornhole, Jenga, checkers, chess, and board games. Come by Glitzy Trends and Glitzy Brew today, 1101 West Dickinson.
Do you know where you can get a great lunch special for a very affordable price? At Bienvenidos Mexican Food Restaurant, of course. Their lunch special is served Monday through Friday during lunchtime. Monday, it's the taco plate. Tuesday, it's the grilled chicken salad. Wednesday, it's Bienvenidos Nachos. Thursday, it's the hamburger basket. And Friday, it's the enchilada plate. You can come by Sunday through Friday from 9 to 11 a.m. for a delicious Mexican-style breakfast. Bienvenidos, open Sunday through Friday, starting at 9 a.m. at 405 East Dickinson.
Ram Country of Fort Stockton has a full-time service department. For all your vehicle needs, visit Ram Country 2603 West Dickinson. Same-day service available on most vehicles. This includes service on Jeep, Ram, Dodge, and Chrysler vehicles. They also have a state-of-the-art tire alignment machine. Ram Country has the top service technicians in the area, so no matter the make or model of your vehicle, they can get you back out on the road safely. Call 432-360-1055 to schedule an appointment today.
When you need supplies in the oil field, the choice is clear. Choose Triple G Supply and Services in Fort Stockton. They have all the oil field supplies you need, including general oil field supplies, PVC pipe and fittings, hydraulic hoses, generators, safety equipment, household supplies, and much more. They also have roustabout services available. Triple G Supply and Services is right here in Fort Stockton at the west end of Dickinson at 1048 Crockett Avenue. Delivery is available to your location. Call 336-8284 Triple G Supply and Services. The Steakhouse Restaurant is back open again after a brief closure with new ownership and management, but still staying in the Pacheco family. The Steakhouse has been serving Fort Stockton and the surrounding area with consistently great food and fast, friendly service. They offer fantastic daily luncheon specials on weekdays at a great value. Each special comes with appropriate sides, soup or salad, and drink. Come by for a great meal. The Steakhouse Restaurant in Fort Stockton at 1100 West Dickinson.
From the borders of the Rio Grande through the badlands of New Mexico and all across the Permian Basin, those who need quality concrete delivered on time and within budget choose Big Bend Concrete. Whether they're pouring a slab for a commercial structure or a specialized pour in the middle of nowhere drilling site, Big Bend Concrete takes pride in getting the job done right the first time. So call 432-837-7179. Big Bend Concrete. Solid.
All right, we're back here at halftime, and let's take a look at our halftime stats. Fort Stockton was outscored 16-12 in the first quarter, but we outscored Andrews 22-19 in the second. So a good offensive quarter for the Panthers in that second, Darrell. And so the Panthers find themselves trailing by just one here at halftime, 35-34.
Yeah, got to hand it to the Panthers. They've come out, and again, a slow start. But we talked about it. I'm impressed with the free throw shooting.
Well,
and that is.
Yeah, you know, Andrews is shooting 50%, 6 out of 12, and we're shooting 75%, 9 out of 12.
And we're getting to the line, and that's something that always works out well.
Kevin Villegas has one for Andrews. Jet Fisher, 14 points, and that includes a couple of threes. He also went inside for a couple of baskets. Kate Adams had one. It was Grant Fitzgerald with three. Garrett Marshall, 10 points. He had three threes all in the first quarter. You know, they had, I think, four threes in the first quarter, only one three in the second quarter, so we did a little better job on that defensively.
AJ, yeah, in fact, he didn't score in the second quarter.
Yeah,
Marshall.
AJ yeah. Mayfield with two and Bryson Diaz with four. And again, they shot 6 out of 12 from the line. Okay, for the Panthers, we had Julian Label with 4 points, Luis Medina with 6, Diego Ronquillo with 10, Kyle Rojeda with 3, Cash Norman with 3, Christian Soto with 3, and Andre Washington with 5. And Darren, you know, Julian had, I thought, a strong first quarter, but then he didn't play much in the second quarter.
Yeah.
We saw Andre Washington come in to sub for him, and Andre had a strong game too, though.
Yeah, you know, and I was wondering, I'm not second guessing the coach, but when they had their big lineup in, you'd think Washington and Julian in at the same time would give them some fits, but but he obviously knows what he's doing. We're right there in the game.
Okay, and we shot 9 out of 12 from the free throw line. We did have Seminole, I believe, coming back. You know, they were trailing at halftime over they were trailing two Monahans, and it was it was 30-25, a halftime lead for Monahans. Now, after three quarters, the Seminole Indians have taken the lead over Monahans 37-35. Seminole had a very close loss to Greenwood their last game, which was Seminole's first loss in district. So that's going to be a nail-biter there in Seminole tonight with them and Monahans. Now, Greenwood is blowing out Pecos tonight 88-30 after three quarters. And so Greenwood is going to go to 7-1, it looks like, in district. And they're the ones that beat Seminole in the last game.
Okay. And Seminole's 7-1, too?
Seminole is 6-1. Greenwood is also 6-1 going into tonight. So Seminole needs to win to keep pace with Greenwood for first place. Yeah, in the district. Okay, we've got two games left after this one. We'll have Greenwood, I believe, here at home on Friday night. And then we will be on the road at Pecos on Tuesday for the Panthers. Now, it depends, you know, when that playoff game for bi-district is. You know, normally the girls will play either on a Monday or Tuesday of next week. So we'll see when that game is scheduled with the girls against Canyon in bi-district.
And that'll be some neutral court somewhere.
Yeah, probably around maybe Seminole. You know,
okay.
You never know. But it very well could be Seminole.
We should make them travel a long ways. It'll help us out.
Yeah. All right, we'll be back in a moment.
Buck's Lube Center is located at 310 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton. They feature quick oil changes, multi-point vehicle checks, inspection stickers, and fuel filters for all vehicles, specializing in mobile oil, but with Motorcraft also in stock. Buck's Lube Center is open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. until 5 p.m. Remember, for reasonable prices and great service, it's Buck's Lube Center, 310 West Dickinson, Fort Stockton. They hope to serve you on every oil change.
Cactus Health is your one-stop health care facility. They care. They offer quality health care for you and your family, including cardiovascular disease care, cholesterol screenings, developmental screenings, diabetes care, family planning, HIV testing, and general primary medical care. Your family is their number one concern. They care. Cactus Health at 700 North Main. Call 336-8110 for information.
All right, we're back, and we just had a three-pointer made by Jet Fisher for the Andrews Mustangs, and they lead it now by 4 points, 38-34, as they cash in on the first basket. We left him all alone, and you can't do that because this guy now has 17 points.
He's channeling Kerry Fisher in the force.
Oh, that's a nice play into Bryson Diaz for Andrews. Fort Stockton, I believe, wants a quick timeout, as Andrews has scored the first 5 points of this quarter. We'll be back in a moment.
Your dreams are what power our community. When it comes to buying a home, starting a business, or tools to help with everyday money management, Citibank is a proud community leader for your financial needs. From personal checking and lending solutions to mobile banking and a suite of business services, Our goal is to help you achieve yours. Citibank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Well, Darrell, not a good start to this third quarter for the Panthers, allowing a three by one of their top. In fact, he is the leading scorer for Andrews right now, allowing a three by him, and then going inside for a great offensive play to their big post, Diaz.
It's what causes a problem for any defense. When you can nail threes, things open up inside as well. So we need to certainly stop the 3 points.
All right, and here we go with the ball. And that pass is tipped out of bounds by Jace McGruff.
He was taking a bite out of the ball.
We've got 7:04 left, third quarter, 40-34. Panthers trail now to Andrews.
I didn't see McGruff's doesn't he always have a magnifying glass and one of those funny hats?
Well, he was dressed like Sherlock Holmes, wasn't he?
Yeah.
But it was a dog.
It was a dog, yeah.
Diego Ronquillo to Julian Leyva.
And when a dog gets called for dribbling on the court, it's really bad.
Well, I tell you, that's a nice move inside by Arian Hernandez, and he draws the foul. Number 11 for Andrews, Cade Adams, call for the foul. You know, in this game, really no one, I don't think, is in foul trouble.
No, they've been pretty well evenly spread out. Everybody's got one.
Arian Hernandez at the free throw line. In and out on that free throw, no good. Brought to you by Rainwater Motor Company.
It's a good-looking stroke.
Arian Hernandez, a 6'2 senior guard at the line again. This one is up and good. All right. That's our first point of the second half right there on a Rainwater Motor Company free throw. We've trailed now by 5, 40-35. 6:35 to go, third quarter. Andrews out front with Jet Fisher. McGruff on the right wing. And now the Panthers, you know, when you come out on the perimeter, that's possibly going to open up the inside, right?
Yeah, but you got to. They'll drain a three.
Oh, yeah, they're a good three-point shooting team. Here comes Andrews working it inside, just outside the lane. Now back to Fisher. He tries a three and drains another one.
And he was well guarded on that one.
He was.
Wasn't just leaving him open. He was well guarded. Oh, Fort Stockton.
Oh, that's a turnover, which results in a fast break basket by Jace McGruff. Now Andrews, all of a sudden, has opened up a double-digit 10-point lead, the biggest lead they've had. And there's another turnover by Fort Stockton.
We can play better than this. There we go.
Ball was – oh, they had a three-on-one after we thought we had a steal. And that was number 45, Bryson Diaz, scoring the basket.
Right now they're hustling.
Man, they have really
– turned up the heat.
Turned up the heat in these third quarter. We have not made a basket, and Andrews has made two threes and three twos. We'll be back in just a moment as a timeout is called. Brought to you by R&K Rentals and Party Supplies.
Are you sick and tired of inflation driving up the price on virtually everything? At CTG Express Oil Change, we have mastered the art of inflation-proof, lightning-fast oil changes. We tell inflation to take a hike with our happy hour discounts every weekday, 11 to 1 p.m., and our service appreciation discounts for local teachers, military, first responders, and correctional officers. We're fast, too, saving you time and money. And remember, at CTG Express, we are the best for the most dependable place to get your state inspection. Come stay with us at CTG Express in Fort Stockton.
All right, Darrell, 7 three-point baskets tonight by Andrews, 3 of them by Garrett Marshall, 4 of them by Jet Fisher.
Yeah, and it's just two guys as far as the three-pointers go.
Yeah.
But, they can hit them.
47-35, Andrews on top by 12 now. This was a one-point game at halftime.
Right.
All right, here's Diego Ronquillo. Why was that not a foul? Can you tell me?
I have no idea.
All right, here is Arian Hernandez stripped to the ball. They really let Andrews get away with something there. I don't understand why that was not a foul.
Yeah, the coach is letting them hear it. I think that one referee double-dribbled his stomach.
Oh, man. All right. Here's a three by Diego Ronquillo. It's off to the left. No good. Rebound by Andrews. And here's Cade Adams coming down with the ball to McGruff. He switches his dribble, almost went inside for a basket. And now they try to find Adams. They turn it over right there.
There we go. We need to.
Arian Hernandez intercepts the ball. Here's Luis Medina.
He was mugged.
Diego Ronquillo, a three ball from the corner, no good. And Andrews with the rebound. It's out of bounds off of Andrews and off of Cade Adams. 4:44 to go in the third. And Darrell, we need to make some points here.
Yeah.
We need some baskets, as we have been outscored in this third quarter big time. 12-1.
And missed a point-blank shot.
Yep, miss a point-blank shot. There's, I tell you, Diego Ronquillo is undersized, but he is a hustler. He got the ball back. Here's Julian Leyva. And that's off the glass. A nice shot by Julian. He stole the ball back.
Yeah.
And he got the ball. And I tell you, you talk about persistence by Julian Leyva. That was a great play by Julian on so many levels.
He needed to step up and be the leader, and he was.
That is Arian Hernandez being called for the foul right near the midcourt line. We're just trying to create steals right there, and we got called for a foul.
Sure. Well, you got to play aggressive. But
yep. 4:13 left, third quarter, 10-point game now. And we had a one-point game at halftime. That's how much Andrews has outscored us here in this third period. Two threes by Fisher, a couple of baskets by Diaz, another basket by McGruff. Here's McGruff on the left wing. And back out to McGruff. Now he goes back out on the perimeter. Here's a three put up, no good. McGruff got a rebound to Diaz, and they just outmaneuvered us on the offensive rebound that time. We need those.
We need the tie ball, and we've got it. So
Bryson Diaz is pretty tough inside for Andrews, as are our big men. But, you know, we've got Washington and Leyva in here at the same time now.
I like that. Counteract some height. Now, why wasn't that a foul?
Why was not that a foul? Yeah, I got you. And here's Leyva.
Nice.
What a beautiful shot by Julian Leyva.
Julian Leyva leading the team. He's
47-39. We trail by eight. We've cut it to single digits again. And here's McGruff. They go inside, and it's a layup by Kevin Villegas.
And that was porous defense right there. I think we're either losing somebody on the inside or.
Diego Ronquillo out front now. Bounce pass to Leyva. Picked off, and then Ronquillo picks it back up. And there's Diego with a three of his own. And that is a triple R welding three-point shot. It's back down to a seven-point lead for Andrews, 49-42. And Diego's had three three-pointers tonight. He is our best three-point shooter. Cash Norman had another one. And now here's Andrews at the free throw line, putting up a shot, no good. And I tell you, Diaz is hard to move out of the way. But finally, we got the rebound by Luis Medina. Man, Diaz is tough inside.
He's a big kid.
219.
Julian's handling him, though.
2:19 to
go.
Here's Andre Washington, left-handed layup, no good. He penetrated in the lane, missed it. Now here's Andrews on the fast break. Punch it back out to the corner. Three-pointer, no good. Diaz with a turnaround, offensive rebound, and jumper is good. He cleaned it up. And Andrews now 51-42 over the Panthers. That's your Little Regina Trucking game score. Here's Leyva. Now near the free throw line, really covered up there. He was double teamed. And now here's Andre Washington. But I like having Andre and Leyva in at the same time.
Forced pass.
What are they going to call here? Whose ball is it going to be?
I think it's Fort Stockton's ball.
Yeah, it is. 1:30 left, third quarter. Here in Fort Stockton tonight against Andrews, and we had a one-point game at halftime. Andrews was leading. Now that big guy, Diaz, goes out for the moment.
He may be winded. But he's played tough.
He has. Diego Ronquillo now to Medina. Back to Ronquillo. Here's Christian Soto. And
we need to make some hay while he's out.
There's Julian Leyva missing the shot that time. And that's a tie ball. Soto reached in and tied it up with Garrett Marshall. Pretty aggressive game right now, but Andrews has got the possession arrow. And they lead by 9 with a minute 12 in the third. Greenwood was all over Pecos tonight in boys action. And it was a close, close game between Seminole. Oh, who made that? Number zero, I believe,
yeah,
Villegas.
Number zero. He just drove right down the floor and nobody stopped him.
Well, here's the ball saved out of bounds, but it's going to be Andrew's ball. Seminole has defeated Monahans tonight.
So they came back and won.
And by 12.
Yeah.
53-41. So Seminole now goes to 7-1 in district play. Monahans drops to 5-3.
So Seminole, Greenwood are tied for the lead.
Yes, and Greenwood's going to beat Pecos tonight. They're leading by a lot. Here's the inbounds play knocked out by Ronquillo. We're nearing the end of the third quarter. We've got 43 seconds left in this period. You okay, Darryl?
I might live.
You and Darren have both been sick. Darren's kind of out sick tonight.
Mine's just a lingering cough.
You're getting over yours.
Yeah.
35 seconds in the third, and it's another foul on Fort Stockton. A blocking foul, I think, on, let me see, do we call it on Kyle Rojero? Number 12, I think.
Yes.
So, Andrews will be inbounding the ball with 33 seconds left in the third. Andrews is up by 11 points now. They missed the shot there. Ball goes out of bounds. It'll be Fort Stockton ball. 53-42. Mustangs over the Panthers. They've had a very good third quarter.
Yeah, it's just rolled over, honestly, in that first minute.
All right, Diego Ronquillo, bounce pass to Soto. Almost overshot him. Ball going to go out of bounds, knocked out by Xavier Ramos for Andrews. Their big man, Diaz, is taking a rest right now, but I'm sure he'll be back soon. Here's the inbounds play. All right, Ronquillo over on the right wing. Puts up a wild shot, and Andrews has the rebound with 4 seconds. Here they come toward the basket. That's a charging foul. No way you could not see that one. That's Aiden Olivas called for the charge.
Oh, there's a way they could not see it. I don't. Dude.
you're right. But they did get that one right.
They got it right.
Kyle Rojero inbounding the ball, and that is a traveling call on Ronquillo. All right, at the buzzer. So that's the end of the third. Andrews leading 53-42. We'll be back in a moment.
Concept Inc. is here to help you with all your oil field and residential needs. They provide licensed septic system installations, site evaluations, roll-off container rentals, and porta-potty rentals, septic tank and grease trap pump outs. Backhoe services and general construction also available. Contact Kobe Tarasas at 432-290-3620. That phone number again is 432-290-3620. Concept Inc. Contessa Ready Mix is now open and ready to serve all your concrete needs. They also offer general construction, precast, material hauling, and sand and gravel. They're located at 2270 Gonzales Loop. For more information, call 432-290-4947. Contessa Ready Mix, owned and operated by Colby Tarasas, serving Fort Stockton and the surrounding area.
Well, we have a final score here. Greenwood has knocked off Pecos big time tonight, 108-43.
That's a lot of points.
That's a lot of points. Pecos goes to 0-8. Greenwood improves to 7-1. So Seminole and Greenwood tied atop the district standings at 7-1 in the boys' division. Monahans in third place at 5-3. If Andrews wins tonight, they'll go to 4-4. We would fall to 1-7, but we're hoping for a comeback here.
Boy, let's get it started right here.
Here's Luis Medina. Yes, a three-point shot by the Panthers. Brought to you by Triple R Welding. And that cuts it back to single digits, the lead. It's an eight-point lead now by Andrews. Here comes Andrews in the lane, and it's going to be a foul on the Panthers.
Well, that was close.
Yeah.
Very close.
Well, when you get that close into the basket, it's hard to get a charge called. I believe it was Kyle Rojedo, maybe, number 12, called for the foul.
Believe so.
Kevin Villegas will go to the line for the Mustangs. And right now we are trailing by 8, 53-45. That's your Little Regina Trucking game score.
Well, Andrews needs to miss a free throw or two here.
And here's Villegas missing that off the front iron.
I did that.
What?
I made him miss.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
All right, here's Villegas again. Cash Norman comes into the ballgame. Cash is a sophomore. Here's Villegas at the line. And the shot is good. All right. Andrews up by 9 now. Luis Medina, bounce pass, stolen away. That's a bad pass. Here's McGruff. And all alone is Jet Fisher. You can't defend that many people in the lane when you don't have your defense down. Oh, that's we stepped over the baseline on the inbounds play.
We never took it out.
Well, they say we turn it over right there. It'll be an Andrews ball.
Bad communication.
Andrews up now by 11 points. They have really pretty much owned the second half. Jace McGruff. Inbounding the ball. Here they come. And they go to their big man again, who's back in the game. Wow. There'll be a foul on Fort Stockton, and they got McGruff, I think, found him open for that basket.
Yeah,
that was a nice assist by Bryson Diaz, their big man.
Yeah. We're just letting them in the inside, and we just can't do anything to stop them. They're always giving an extra pass for an assist.
And that was the fourth foul on Kyle Rojedo. And he goes out, and here comes Evan Cordero in the game. And McGruff will be at the free throw line to try to complete a three-point play. And it's good. Oop. Andrews now up 59-45.
Beautiful pass.
Oh, man, that was a missed shot. But there's the lay-in by Christian Soto, who cleaned that up with an offensive rebound and a turnaround jumper. Here come the Mustangs now with Jet Fisher. And here's Diaz just backs into the lane. And Cash Norman helping out right there. And that's what you got to do on that guy. Instead of letting him back in the lane, double-team him from front and back, right? That's a foul on Andrews.
That's an example of the difference right there.
Yeah.
We have a guy under the basket by himself, and he just doesn't handle the pass, and the defense catches up.
Called a foul on Andrews that time. I believe we've got a timeout by the Mustangs. We'll take a timeout with them, and this is an R&K Reynolds and Party Supplies timeout. We'll be back in a moment.
Designer Carpets and Interiors has become known in Fort Stockton as the remodeling experts. They will be glad to put together a free estimate on just about any remodeling project, always keeping in mind your budget. They also can help with ideas and designs for your project to upgrade your home and add to its value. They also have all types of the latest and most modern flooring, including carpet, tile, hardwood, laminates, custom cabinetry, countertops, and much more. Call Designer Carpets and Interiors today at 336-6591.
All right, we're back for the last 6:37 of this game. We've got Andrews leading 59-47. Darrell, a one-point game has now turned into a double-digit Andrews lead.
Yeah, that first minute of the second half just killed us. And you know, we are improving. I'm impressed with a lot of things that we're doing. But a run like that'll gut you in a game.
And we have turned it over more here in the second half than we did in the first. Cash Norman with a three, and it will miss. Triple R Welding three-point attempt. Here comes the Mustangs from the backcourt. Going to have a foul in the backcourt on Cash Norman. I believe it's his second.
He's a hustling, but you really don't want to foul at the backcourt.
No, McGruff inbounds the ball. We've got 6:20 left in the game. Andrews is up by 12. Mustangs with McGruff going inside.
Good defense.
Here's a fast break for Fort Stockton, and it's down to Arian Hernandez, who scores the layup basket on the M&J Fast Lube fast break. Under 6 minutes to go. We cut it back to 10. And here's Andrews, a tripping foul inside on Cash Norman. His third foul.
Yeah.
I don't think that was intentional.
No, I don't think it was intentional. It was a hustle. It was him hustling, trying to steal the ball.
Andrews will have an inbounds play right on their baseline. Guard Diaz, because this guy is something else inside. All right. Oh, man. Blocked by Evan Cordero. Nice block by Evan. Ball goes out of bounds off of Andrews. We'll get it back. Nice defensive play.
Good help defense there.
You know, Evan's got some height. He's 6'3". Here's the inbounds play. Goes to Arian Hernandez. Now here's Andre Washington on the left wing. Now Cordero. Here's a three by Soto. Yes! Sure. Christian Soto with a three-point shot. Brought to you by Triple R Welding.
We need three more of those.
Yeah.
And three stops.
With none of theirs.
Yeah.
59-52. Fort Stockton down by 7. Cash playing a little bit too aggressively there. And the ball goes out of bounds off of Andrews. And we'll get it back. All right. That's a good break. I think we have four fouls and they have one in this quarter.
Yeah, that's.
Here's Evan Cordero. Now Soto with a long two. It's good again for Christian Soto.
Excellent.
Soto, 7 points in this quarter. And it brings us back within 5. Here's Jet Fisher now out front for the Mustangs. He goes inside, intercepted by Andre Washington. Here come the Panthers going to the hoop. And the lay-in misses, but the putback is good by Evan Cordero.
All right, just like that, we're within 3.
We are within 3. Andrews up 59-56. I wonder if Andrews is going to call a timeout soon. Plenty of time left in this game, 4:40 to go. And now here's Andrews going inside. A layup misses. Andre Washington with the rebound. Panthers have had a nice run here to get back into this game. We only trail by 3. Evan Cordero on the left wing up near the top of the key, triple teamed, and he passes off to Washington. Here's Arian Hernandez. Back out to Washington. Here's Evan at the top of the key, tries a 3 ball. It won't go, and Andrews has the rebound. Here come the Mustangs. And they're going to say it's a foul and a basket. Jet Fisher will get the basket and a foul on Cordero.
I don't care for that call. I mean, it's at best it's a no call to me.
All right, but Jet Fisher goes to the line to try to give.
As I said, he got called for double dribbling his stomach earlier in the game. the ref.
Yes. Jet Fisher made the basket. He's going to try for the three-point play. And it is no good off the front iron. 5-point game, 61-56. That's your Little Regina Trucking game score.
Nice pass.
Oh, man. Oh. Well, Cash Norman had his shot blocked. I thought that was close to goaltending. And that ball goes out of bounds. Will it be
Fort Stockton ball?
Okay. 3:44 left in the ball game.
We came
back within 3. Now we're down by 5.
Yeah, you got to hand it to them. They have never quit. They're scrappy.
All right, the Panthers with Washington inbounding. Oh, bad pass on the inbounds play. Andrews, Kevin Villegas steals it. Now we steal it back. Here's Norman. Bounce pass. Soto puts up the shot.
And got fouled.
No good, but he got fouled.
All right.
Didn't see who got called for that foul.
Looks like maybe 11.
Maybe.
Yeah,
I
number
guess that's
11,
right.
That's yep. three for him.
And what? We're still not in the bonus. That's only two fouls.
Well, I thought he was shooting when they fouled him.
Maybe. Well, they're not going to allow that.
Okay.
So we've got Andre Washington set to inbound for the Panthers. We need a basket here. We're down by five. Got to hurry. And here's Evan Cordero. Nice inbounds play. All right, 3:27 in the ball game. Here's Cordero going to the hoop. Nope. It's Ronquillo with a three, and he makes it. Diego Ronquillo, his fourth three-pointer of the night. Turns it into a two-point game with 3:10 to go in the fourth quarter. Andrews fades around to the right wing. Bring it back to the top of the key.
Watch him. He's
man-to-man defense right now by the Panthers. And they go inside, and it's almost lost, but Andrews gets it back. Oh, that was a hacking foul. I think they're going to call a foul on Fort Stockton here. I don't know. Yeah, that's Diego Ronquillo. He just kind of hacked the player going into the lane with his arm.
He was trying to steal the ball and got arm.
So Andrews is in the bonus, of course.
Yeah, and that's bad.
That's one thing, Darryl, that hurt our girls in that first game.
Yeah.
They were not in the bonus. But we should have fouled quicker. Kevin Villegas going to the line for Andrews. Here's the shot. That's no good.
They have not been good free throw shooters today.
No,
not great. Not horrible, but not that good either.
Kevin Villegas at the line. Another free throw coming. A two-point game. Andrews 61, Fort Stockton 59. Villegas at the line shoots, scores that one. And it's a three-point game. Here come the Panthers. Evan Cordero across the midcourt line. And here's Ronquillo with a three. It's good again for Diego Ronquillo.
Tie game.
Ties the game up with a triple R welding three-pointer by Diego. And Andrew's going to lose the ball to Andre Washington. Here come the Panthers with Cordero. Have a chance to take the lead. Ronquillo with a three. No, it won't go.
That was forced. I would have liked to have seen it set up.
Well, that was a long one. Jet Fisher now out front for Andrews. A tie game. We got a timeout, Andrews. And our R&K Rentals and Party Supplies timeout. We'll be back in a moment.
The First National Bank of Fort Stockton is proud to be the first local bank to offer a new mobile check deposit app. Yes, the First National Bank, always at the cutting edge of technology, is now offering a mobile app with which you can take a picture of a check and it will be immediately accepted as a deposit to your account. It's just another great innovation through the latest technology from the friendly First National Bank of Fort Stockton. Stop by for all the details at the First National Bank, 1000 West Dickinson, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender.
The schools of Fort Stockton ISD provide comprehensive educational services in our community. Hello, this is Dr. Gabe Zamora, Superintendent. Whatever the educational need, we are committed to doing our best. This includes providing a safe environment and opportunities to improve the education of your student. We are extremely proud of our students and their accomplishments. We are proud to sponsor FSISD sports broadcasts for those unable to attend. Go Panthers and go Prowlers!
Okay, we're back with more Panther basketball. Panthers have come storming back here in the fourth quarter to tie the game up 62-62. Luis Medina had a three. Diego's had two threes. Christian Soto had a three. Christian Soto's had another couple of baskets. Evan Cordero a basket and Arian Hernandez with a basket.
Good, really good comeback for the Panthers.
Yep.
Of course, we'd like to close it out, but they really fought hard.
You know, this Andrews team is not bad. So if we can beat this team, it's a feather in our cap. That's a good deal. Here's the inbounds play. And that's a travel, a double dribble on Andrews. So we got the crowd behind us. There's certainly more Panther fans here than there are Andrews fans. And here come the Panthers. Evan Cordero across the midcourt line. A three, no good. Andrews with a strong rebound there by Garrett Marshall. Hey, boy, he really controlled that ball there. And here comes Andrews in the lane, and it's tipped. And the ball stolen. Here's Diego Ronquillo, fast break. Layup is good. And that is a M&J fast loop, fast break, and the Panthers take the lead 64-62.
3 seconds there.
A minute 24 left. Here's Andrews going inside. They throw it away. Panthers will get a turnover with a minute 19 left. Let's see. The Panthers have three timeouts left. Andrews has two timeouts left.
They could have called 3 seconds on that their post. Yeah, there we go.
That's going to be a foul on Andrews.
We need to get to the bonus. We'd be shooting.
Yep, that's three fouls now on the Mustangs. We have five, so they're in the bonus. We are not. Here's Washington now bringing it up the court. Panthers with a two-point lead. 64-62 after a good fourth quarter for the Panthers. Cordero to Washington. Oh, man, why was that not a foul? And we got a timeout, Fort Stockton. Okay, we'll be back. More Panther basketball coming up in a moment after this R&K Reynolds and Party Supplies timeout.
Hernandez Sanitation in Fort Stockton proudly serves a large portion of West Texas with sanitation services, including the oil field for portable toilets, holding tanks, septic tank service, grease trap service, or large roll-off trash containers. Contact Hernandez Sanitation today by calling owner and operator Joe Angel Hernandez at 432-336-3803. Hernandez Sanitation, a proud member of the Fort Stockton community, always supporting all the athletic and extracurricular activities in Fort Stockton schools. Heritage Funeral Home in Fort Stockton is here to serve you and your family in times of need. Remember, not only is everybody somebody in Fort Stockton, Texas, but everybody is treated like family at Heritage Funeral Home. When they receive your loved one into their care, you can be sure that they will honor your family's heritage. Call Heritage Funeral Home at 432-336-3939 or go by 301 North Main Street and allow them to help you pre-plan your or your family's final farewell.
Well, the Panthers have come really storming back with 4 3-pointers total in this fourth quarter. And another 4 regular baskets, 2-point baskets. And so the Panthers are now leading 64-62 and have possession with 58 seconds left. And our coach calls a timeout. And, Andrews steals a ball on the inbounds play. Now they've got possession and trailing by two with 50 seconds. Don't let him shoot the three ball.
There it is right here.
All right, Andrews goes inside, and a foul is called. I would rather take my chances with them shooting free throws than baskets, because they have not been that great from the line. But that is Evan Cordero being called for the foul. And Jet Fisher, who
I'd rather it not be Fisher.
No, I mean, he's not that great at the line. First free throw is no good.
That's a big free throw right there.
All right, and that's a big miss.
Yes.
And Jet Fisher goes to the line again. Panthers are leading 64-62, 40 seconds left. And Fisher at the line again. It is good. A one-point game. And a timeout is called, I believe.
Smart.
Yeah, it's a timeout. And we'll take this R&K Reynolds and Party Supplies timeout with 40 seconds and the Panthers leading by one. We'll be back in a moment.
Julie's Easy Press Cleaners is ready to serve you with all your laundry cleaning needs, from drop-off to pickup. You'll enjoy not having to do the washing, drying, or pressing. It's done for you. Whether it's a party, office meeting, or lunch with friends, show up dressed for success. Because at Julie's Easy Press, they know when you look good, you feel good. Julie's Easy Press, 1101 North Front Street, or call 336-6601.
At K-Bob Steakhouse in Fort Stockton, we pride ourselves on great food, great service, and great atmosphere. We work hard every day to make sure that every trip to K-Bob's is worth your time. Whether it's lunch with friends, a family dinner, or a special occasion, K-Bob's is always here to serve you the food America loves. K-Bob Steakhouse, Fort Stockton, 2800 West Dickinson.
Okay, here we are.
M&J Trucking Services supports our Fort Stockton Panther and Prowler athletes.
Sorry about that, folks. We'll get back to that. But we've got a one-point lead with 40 seconds left in this ballgame. And we've got a very important inbounds play here. Andrews is going to try everything they can to try to steal this ball, one way or another. Here's the inbounds play to Evan Cordero. Evan Cordero does a good job, keeps dribbling, and he is
fouled
from behind and shoved. And that is how many fouls on Andrews? That'll be four.
They got one more to give.
One more to give. That's number 11, Cade Adams.
Well, that's the last one to give. We're shooting after this.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah. We're shooting after this if they foul us again. We need to inbound it to Diego if we can, because Diego's a pretty good free throw shooter. All right, here he comes down the court. And that is a foul on Andrews, I think. Yeah, number 3, Jet Fisher, I think.
All right, we need to drain these.
Did they call it on number 3? Or no, I think it was. All right.
Two fouls for him.
Yeah, that's right. Andre Washington at the line for the Panthers. We lead by one. Here's the free throw brought to you by Rainwater Motor Company. Boom. Good! Panthers are on top by 2. Andre Washington with another Rainwater Motor Company free throw. In comes Julian Leyva to the ball game. Diego backs up. All right, here's Andre. Lots of pressure on this free throw. It is good. Brought to you by Rainwater Motor. It's a 3-point Panther lead. Here come the Mustangs. We've got a timeout by Andrews. And we'll be back with more Panther basketball in a moment.
M&J Trucking Services supports our Fort Stockton Panther and Prowler athletic teams and wants you to know that there's a locally owned and operated oilfield trucking company that can handle your vacuum truck and water hauling in the surrounding area. It's M&J Trucking in Fort Stockton, offering 24-hour-a-day, 7-day-a-week vacuum truck and water hauling service. Contact M&J Trucking today at 290-4510. M&J Trucking, owned and operated by Martin Ibarra, proudly supporting the Fort Stockton Panthers and Prowlers.
Sawyer Insurance Agency has 6 locations in West Texas to serve you, including 706 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton and 1502 South Stockton Avenue in Monahans, along with offices in Pecos, Midland, Lubbock, and Amarillo. They offer the most complete line of commercial and personal insurance from workers' comp, general liability, business and personal auto, commercial property, equipment, oil and gas, farm and ranch, and home insurance. Contact Clyde, Nathan, or Travis Sawyer today by calling 336-7543 or 943-9600.
All right, Darrell, we're back. This could be an exciting finish here for the Panthers. We've come all the way back in this fourth quarter, down by double digits, and now we're ahead by 3. 66-63 with 21 and a half seconds left. Andrews is going to inbound the ball after their timeout. We need to guard the 3 shot for sure. They're a good 3-point shooting team, as we have seen.
We need them.
All right, Kevin Villegas. Here's Andrews in the corner now, and they will go for a 3. It's no good. Andre Washington has the rebound out to Cash Norman. Julian Leyva, that's a very smart deal of, we got a foul.
Yeah, on Andrews.
On Andrews.
They grabbed him. They had to. They had to foul.
3.9 seconds. We can put it out of reach and make it a double, a two-possession game here. Who did they call the foul on? Not sure, but it's Julian Leyva at the line. He's 0 for 1 tonight, but he has 8 points in this game.
Needs a free throw right
here. And 2 free throws for Julian. Rainwater Motor Company free throws. First one.
Get in there.
No, oh. It won't go. It rolled around. Here's Julian. Can make it a two-possession game right here. Let's go, Julian. Free throw. Short, no good.
But we got the rebound.
Rebound by Washington. He's fouled. Very quickly by Andrews, number 24, Garrett Marshall.
They weren't counting on us getting a rebound.
And Andre Washington, what a great rebound. That could seal the game.
A good move by our coach to put in rebounders on this.
Yep. Andre at the line. 2.3 seconds. Here's the
shot.
There it is. No, it won't go.
Oh,
here's Andre Washington with another Rainwater Motor Company free throw. In comes Arian Hernandez. Andre Washington.
You got it, Andre.
At the line. Let's make it, Andre. 2.3 seconds. Here's the shot. Boom. It's good. Makes it a two-possession game.
Just let him throw it.
67-63. Andrews with a three-pointer at the buzzer, and the Panthers win over the Andrews Mustangs 67-63. Andrews falls to 3-5 in district play. Fort Stockton improves to 2-6, and so that's a great comeback job tonight by the Panthers.
Great comeback by
the
Panthers.
We'll be back to wrap up the ball game after this.
Porky's Ice House in Fort Stockton is the place to get your drinks and snacks in Fort Stockton, with two convenient drive-through lanes open 7 days a week for teas, lemonades, and fountain drinks with added flavors upon request and much more. Go by Porky's Ice House, and remember, happy hour is each day from 4 to 6 p.m. with all drinks any size for just a dollar. They also make popular Clamato, Squirt, Topo Chico, and Jerky Preparados that are delicious, along with nachos. Porky's Ice House, 1401 West Dickinson in Fort Stockton.
Need a quick, efficient oil change? M&J Fast Lube at 116 West Dickinson is here to serve you. Martine and Julia Ibarra invite you to stop by. They have great service, and they offer auto oil and lube services with the top major oil brands. They also offer state inspections and vehicle washing and cleaning, or you can get your vehicle completely detailed. It'll look like you just bought it. That's M&J Fast Lube, 116 West Dickinson, supporting Panther and Prowler Sports. Go Blue!
Stockton Glass and Mirror is locally owned and operated and welcomes you to give them a call for a free estimate on any job. They're your premier commercial and residential glass installation company, proudly serving the Trans-Pecos and Big Bend for more than 30 years. Stockton Glass and Mirror offers quality glass products professionally installed, along with broken glass repairs, shower enclosures, and much more. Open Monday through Friday, 8 to noon and 1 to 5. Call 336-3152 or go by 202 East 5th Street. Stockton Glass and Mirror, glass west of the Pecos.
Triple R Welding, located at 2215 West 9th, is here for all your residential, commercial, or oil field needs. From roustabout, hotshot, and certified welding to building and installing your own personalized one-of-a-kind fence and entrance. Bring them your ideas and they can make it happen. Call 336-5289. Triple R Welding. They can weld anything except a broken heart and the crack of dawn. Visit them today at 2215 West 9th Street or call 336-5289.
All right, we're back to wrap up the ball game tonight for you. It is a final score here tonight as the Fort Stockton Panthers defeat the Andrews Mustangs tonight. Final score here is 67-63. Is that correct? I believe that's right.
What a comeback.
They already turned off the scoreboard, but I believe that was the final.
Usually when on a game like that, you leave the scoreboard on until the next day.
Yeah, you know, that's for sure.
I was the Andrews cheerleaders and their mascot, the Mustang.
Yeah.
I was asking him why the long face.
Like the bartender, right?
Yeah.
When the horse walks into the bar. Okay, so, yeah, what a comeback. The Panthers outscored Andrews 25-10 in the fourth quarter. How about that?
That's a comeback. When you are down, we were trying to decide 12, 13 points.
Yep. We were down by 12.
And it really looked rough Yep. But they kept after it. I'm impressed. I really
All right.
am.
Kevin Villegas for Andrews, 7 points. Jet Fisher, 25 for Andrews. Kate Adams, 1. Jace McGruff, 5. Grant Fitzgerald, 3. Garrett Marshall, 10. All in the first quarter, but we shut him down after that. A.J. Mayfield, 2. Bryson Diaz with 10. And they shot just 10 out of 20 from the free throw line. The Panthers, Julian Leyva, 8 points tonight. Luis Medina, 9. Diego Ronquillo, 21 points, and that includes 5 3-pointers. Arian Hernandez, 3. Kyle Rojero had 3. Cash Norman, 3. Christian Soto had 10 with 1 3-pointer. Evan Cordero, 2. Andre Washington had 8. And the Panthers shot 13 out of 20 from the free throw line tonight. So the all of the boys' finals now. Fort Stockton beats Andrews 67-63. Seminole beats Monahans 53-41, I believe, and it was Greenwood over Pecos 108-43. So the updated district standings, Seminole and Greenwood tied at 7-1 atop the standings. Monahans at 5-3, Andrews at 3-5, Fort Stockton now at 2-6, and Pecos drops to 0-8. So we have still, you know, Greenwood to go on Friday. Mm-hmm. Then we have Pecos on the road on Tuesday. I think the Panthers can certainly beat Pecos. Greenwood, they're a very good team. So we could still wind up realistically with 3 wins in this district.
It probably should wind up with 3 wins.
Yep.
We're improving.
Yep.
I don't remember exactly what happened in Andrews, but we didn't play this well.
No.
And so.
But great job by the Panthers, a great comeback, outscoring them 25-10 in the fourth to win it. 67-63 over the Mustangs. Our Prowlers lose tonight to Andrews by 1 point, but the Prowlers have clinched a playoff spot and will be playing Canyon and Bi-District either probably Monday or Tuesday of next week, and we'll find out more about that later. That's going to wrap it up. Ken Ripley and Daryl Scott saying goodnight from the Special Events Center.
You've been listening to Fort Stockton High School Panther Basketball on KFST AM and FM, KFSTRadio.com, and KFSC's Facebook and YouTube pages. Panther Basketball has been brought to you by Amistad Motors, NG Miles at Turnkey Realty, Glitzy Trends and Glitzy Brew, Bienvenidos Mexican Food, Rim Country, Triple G Supply and Services, Rainwater Motor Company, The Steakhouse Restaurant, Big Ben Concrete, Bucks Lube Center, Cactus Health Services, Citibank, Concept Inc., Contessa Ready Mix, CTG Express, Designer Carpets and Interiors, The First National Bank, Fort Stockton ISD, Fort Stockton Insurance, The Guadalajara Mexican Grill, Hernandez Sanitation, Heritage Funeral Home, Julie's Easy Press, K-Bob Steakhouse, M&J Trucking, M&J Fast Loop, Sawyer Insurance, Porky's Ice House, Stockton Glass and Mirror, Triple R Welding, Weiss Tire, Salceda Urgent Care and Family Medicine, Sagebrush Cafe, Permian Basin Abstract, West Texas Eye Care, Pecos County State Bank, Little Regina Trucking, R&K Rentals and Party Supplies, and by Besitos de Azúcar. Thanks for tuning in for Panther Basketball.